Hello and welcome to WZBC Sports. My name is Jacob Lassner. I'm joined alongside by Reynolds Johoson and Brendan Mahoney up here in the booth at Xcel Energy Center here in Minnesota for the 2024 NCAA Men's National Championship game between your Boston College Eagles and the Denver Pioneers. Guys, how are you guys feeling tonight?
Pretty honored. I think it's an honor to be able to cover this game alongside two broadcasters that are as great as you guys are. So I'm truly thrilled to be here.
On top of broadcaster, we have two teams who are phenomenal, have worked so hard to get here, especially as we've been watching Boston College this entire season. They've shown up to perform just about every night, and I think it's paid off. They only have 5 losses on the season, and they're here in the national championship after shutting out Michigan 4-0 in a dominant performance. I hope they can carry that on to today, Jacob.
100%, guys. Now let's go through the lineups for both these teams. First off, for the Denver Pioneers, we've got Sam Harris, Tristan Bros, and Jack Devine. Brendan, anything you want to say about those three fine players?
Yeah, important to note that Sam Harris has been elevated to this line, and Massimo Rizzo has been sent down to the fourth line. I think the purpose of this is to even out the lines on Denver a little bit, just because BC has a lot of depth. I think balancing that out with star power along all four lines is important for this Denver team.
100%. Second line, McCain Webster, the captain of this team, Aiden Thompson, and Miko Matika. Third line, Rieger Lorenz, Kieran Sebrian, and Jared Wright. And then on the fourth line, Massimo Rizzo, Carter King, and Connor Capani. Brendan, what could you say about the fourth line of Denver? Is it really a fourth line?
No, all three of these players, the three assistant captains, are all incredible players, especially Massimo Rizzo, who's coming back from injury. This is going to be his second game back. Obviously, these are talented players, as well as now we see the goalie, Matt Davis, who's been really a clutch god this season. 2 overtime wins in these NCAA tournament playoff games. So I think we're going to look for a good game from him as well.
100%. And then on defense, they've got Sean Behrens, Zeev Buyum as their first pairing. Brendan, what can you tell us about Zeev and Reynolds? What can you guys tell me about Zeev Buyum?
Zeev Buyum is electric, and he might be the best defender in the NCAA. I mean, just on top of his offense production, he's an absolute star. And there's a reason he's projected to go top 5 in this year's draft.
Yeah, I think he's actually probably going to be the first defenseman drafted this year. Zeev's a talented player, and his brother, Shai, is accompanied by Boston Buckberger on the second defensive pair.
Yes, can we talk a little bit about that second pair? What kind of energy does Shai bring to that second pair, guys?
Yeah, I think Shai's obviously a great player. People think about Zeev specifically, but Shai's also a second-round draft pick for Detroit in 2021. He's also an offensive-minded defenseman with 28 assists on the season, 7 goals, so 35 points. As we hear some boos rain in for Cutter Gauthier, but that's expected now.
100%. And then in goal, they're going to have Matt Davis, the junior, out of Calgary, Alberta. Brendan, we talked a little bit at the top about Matt Davis, and I'm sure we'll get to this again later. What can you say about him before we head to the national anthem?
I think perhaps one of the most impressive things about Matt Davis is how he held up in that double overtime win versus UMass in the first round of the NCAA tournament, and then went out 2 days later and beat Cornell.
So we're going to take a quick break for the national anthem, and then we'll be live on WZBC Newton.
Oh, say can
Well, hello and welcome to WZBC Newton. Again, my name is Jacob Lassner, joined alongside by Reynolds Johoson and Brendan Mahoney. We just went through the starting lineups for Denver. We're going to get to Boston College right now. Oscar Yelvik, Cutter Gauthier, and Andre Gasol on that first line for Boston College. Second line, the kid line, the freshman line, the USA line, whatever you want to call them. We got them. Gabe Perreault, Will Smith, and Ryan Leonard on that second line. And then Jamie Armstrong, the overtime hero, Jack Malone, and Colby Ambrosio to his right. On that third line for Boston College, as we observe the ceremonial puck drop here from the Xcel Energy Center. Connor Joyce, Mike Posma, and Gentry Schamberger make up that fourth line. Brendan and Reynolds, who stands out to you in that BC lineup? What should who should people be looking out for tonight?
Obviously you should be looking out for that second and first line. It's so much talent. First-round draft picks among them. Obviously, Cutter Gauthier, Hobie Baker finalist yesterday. It didn't go his way, but we heard rumblings that a hat trick might be on the way from an insider source. But you know, we'll see about that one. And obviously, the kid line is disgusting. They've been absolutely phenomenal. Will Smith, 2 goals yesterday, or not yesterday, but Friday or Thursday. And I think he looks to continue that. I'm sure he probably feels a bit worried. You know, he didn't get that Hobie finalist, even though he led the nation in points. And you know, the Eagles team here, they're ready.
Yeah, I mean, let's talk about those three snubs for a second. First off, Jacob Fowler did not win the Mike Richter Award yesterday, given to the best goaltender in all of college hockey. That was one of my bold predictions from earlier in this season. Jacob Fowler will be starting in net, and the team is huddled around Jacob Fowler right now as there's about 40 seconds until puck drop here at the Xcel Energy Center. Let's get to the defense. Drew Fortescue, Eamon Powell on that first pairing. We've talked so much about Eamon, about Drew Fortescue. Brendan, I'll give you a chance to talk about Eamon Powell.
Yeah, obviously the development of Eamon Powell, not only as a player, but as a leader, is what has brought this team to this place. Obviously we have talent, but without leadership, talent means nothing, and I think Eamon has brought that this year.
100%, second pairing, Jakob Bengtsson and Lucas Gustafsson. Bengtsson has been solid, but we talked about during the Michigan game, Gustafsson was pretty good too, guys.
Yeah, he did a great job of eliminating those zone entries that Michigan had so many of. I mean, Michigan was just getting suffocated, even though they were kept coming down and down and down on the Eagles. Players like Gustafsson were just able to get him to the side and eliminate those high-quality chances, Jacob.
100%. And then on that third pairing, Aiden Hurshuk and Aaron Manetian. Hurshuk has been a solid defender all year for this Eagles team. He's really good along the boards, getting the puck back, getting those pucks back for BC, as well as laying those big hits and blocking shots as well. He, I believe, is the team leader in block shots.
Yeah, I think it's going to be a great game defensively for Boston College, and hopefully offensively as we look to see some success on the scoreboard.
Well, we're about to get started here in the Xcel Energy Center. Puck is down. Boston College wins the faceoff. Drew Fortescue has it in the defensive zone over for his D partner, Eamon Powell. Looks to get the puck over to Gasso in the offensive zone. Curls off a hit. Taken away, though, by Bros. It's in the corner. Looks like Denver comes out with the puck. On the puck now is Rizzo. Can't get it. Gasso sends it in deep for BC. Taken back, though, by Sam Harris out of San Diego, California. Harris is going to send it into the neutral zone where Boston College is going to collect. Drew Fortescue has it in the defensive zone over for Powell on the right side of the ice. Back for Fortescue. Fortescue looks to find Gauthier in the middle of the ice. It's taken away, though, by Carter King, one of the assistant captains for this team. Will Smith in the neutral zone. Back for Hurshuk. He's going to skate back into our defensive zone and send it into the neutral zone. But here comes Perreault trying to find Leonard. Can't get it to him. Will Smith. Back for Fortescue. Now it's Hurshuk in the defensive zone. He has his head up in the neutral zone. He's going to rim it all the way down. Goes off the referee and goes into the corner. Behrens on the puck for Denver. And then chipped away by Ziv Bouyim. And then played into the offensive zone of the Denver Pioneers. The national champions from just 2 years ago in the state of Boston. What a full circle moment this has been for all of us here. Here's Will Smith through the neutral zone. Can't dangle his way past two players. Here comes Denver on a 2-on-1 shot. Save made by Fowler. That shot was taken by Matika. Puck's in the corner. Now it is at the hash marks. Denver has it. Below the goal line, moving in front. Can't get it. Here is Denver again. Thompson at the top of the circle. He has his head up in the offensive zone. Perreault trying to poke it away. Thompson still has a chance. Perreault does a nice job of taking the puck back for BC. Lays a nice hit on Thompson. And then Minetti and collects it for the Eagles.
Yeah, overall, great shift defensively there, and probably the only shift that BC has been on the defensive zone.
So, Aaron Manetian has the puck. He gets it over for Jack Malone. Through the neutral zone he goes. Over for Ambrosio, left-hand side. Armstrong looking at the top of the circle, sends it in deep for BC. Armstrong has it again. Good muscle play from him. Gets it to the point. Gustafson, he takes a shot. It's blocked in front. Into the corner it goes. Jack Malone, down low for Jamie Armstrong. Nice cycle. In front, Gustafson, blocked in front by Capone. And then here comes Denver the other way. Capone has the puck on the backhand, looking for his line mate. Can't get it to him. Taken away by BC. Off the glass and into the neutral zone, the puck goes. Anderson has it. He gets it over for his D partner, Olvstad, and he's going to send it in deep for Denver. And an icing has been called, so Boston College will get the first whistle of the game. And then they're going to have an offensive zone draw here. Guys, what do you want to see?
Yeah, I think we're going to hopefully see a good shot here. Denver's been out there for a little while. BC's going to put that first line out there, which is no surprise to me. So I think we're going to have probably maybe even a quick shot off the faceoff.
17:31 to go in this first period. The score remains 0-0 between Denver and Boston College. Cutter Gauthier set to take the draw here for BC. He wins it back. Delving takes a shot. It just goes wide. Hershuk at the point, can't keep it in the zone. He tracks back into the defensive zone, has his head up, finds Jelvik, skate-to-stick transition in the defensive zone. Jelvik with his head up through the middle of the ice, looking for an option. Dangles past two players, Gauthier takes a shot, rebound, off the post, Gasso can't finish. Now it's Hershuk at the point, just narrowly keeps it in, just kidding, it's offsides.
That was such a great opportunity for BC, just absolutely squandered. I mean, that shot's an inch to the left and that goes in every single time. I mean, that's just one of those great plays where you see the puck go around and just perfect end up. Oh, just right on the edge of the post. That's a really big missed opportunity by the Eagles to go up once again.
Yeah, tough. Matt Davis was really out of position on that one. I thought we were going to have a shot at that. I think the momentum carried Andre Gasso to a misplaced shot.
100%. 17:10 to go in the first period. Denver leads the shot battle 1-0. Fowler steered it aside. But we have a face-off in the neutral zone, won by Denver. They have it in their defensive zone. Boston Buckberger sends it over for Lorenz. He's going to send it in deep. Fortescue has it for BC. Does a nice sidestep. Gets it over his D partner, Powell. Powell sends it in the offensive zone, but it goes. It skies into the air and into the crowd of the Denver faithful in the right corner of the offensive zone for Boston College. We'll have another face-off in the neutral zone.
Yeah, I think we have a really Denver-heavy crowd here, but the BC band is carrying the momentum. It's really all I can hear at this moment. But yes, there are a lot of Denver fans here, and they were hard booing when Cutter Gauthier came out.
So Will Smith, Gabe Pro, Ryan Leonard out there for BC. Faceoff won back by Thompson. Zeev Bouyim has the puck in the Denver defensive zone. He plays it off the boards, looking for Webster, the captain of this Denver team. Webster off the boards into the offensive zone. Eamon Powell over for Fortescue. Fortescue, middle of the ice, finds Perreault. He's going to tap it into the offensive zone. Zeev Bouyim has the puck for Denver. Nice pass by him. It's Webster into the offensive zone, taken away by Fortescue. Through the middle of the ice goes Ryan Leonard. He's got space down the right-hand side. Decides to curl back into the defensive zone with the puck. Gets it back for Fortescue. Fortescue with his head up in the defensive zone. Finds, I believe that is Leonard, and then it's chipped into the offensive zone by Leonard and then played by Davis to his defenseman. And here comes Denver the other way. They have the puck. Into the offensive zone they go. Down the right-hand side, it is Rizzo. He's trying to look in front. Finds his line mate. It's at the point. Behrens, he's looking for a shot. Blocked in front by Fortescue. Rebound collected by Denver. Chipped out by Will Smith into the neutral zone. Behrens then rims it back around for Denver. Gustafson collecting for BC. Gets it back for Bankston. Below the goal line, he has his head up and finds, trying to find Malone, but it's taken away, though, by Devine. It's in the defensive zone of Denver. Shai Bouyim has the puck for Denver. He gets it in deep for Denver, but it'll be an icing as Aiden Hershuk wins the battle to get there, but that's going to be contested by all the Denver fans here, guys.
Yeah, I don't think Hershuk won that battle. I think Bros beat him by half an inch. I don't know if that should have been an icing, but we'll take it.
15:42 to go in the first period. Only one shot on goal for both these teams. That shot is attributed to Denver. Andre Gasso had a grade A-plus scoring chance, but he just hit off the post with about 17 minutes to go in this game. But now it's 15:42 to go in this game. BC has yet to register a shot. That one's going to be a big one. Face off one back, Aiden Hershuk, left point, looking for an option. Gets it over for Jelvik, goes under his stick, into the corner it goes. Shai Bouyim on the puck, gets it over for Rizzo. He's carrying it through the neutral zone, sends it in deep for the Pioneers. Fowler taps it behind the goal. Minetian trying to get it out for BC. Puck is in the corner. Rizzo digs it out for Denver. Now it is Bros. He has it at the top of the circle, sends it in deep. Rizzo trying to be knocked off the puck is Minetian. Can't get it, but Gauthier trying to chip it out. John on goal from Denver into the glove of Fowler with 15:11 to go in the first period. That's the second shot on goal this game. Fowler looks pretty composed out there, guys.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more. And I think throughout the first 5 minutes of this game, there's really maybe been 30 seconds of good offensive zone time for Denver. BC's really controlling the pace so far. But Denver was able to get a good shot off there. Kind of a nothing shot, but a shot nonetheless.
Yeah, I mean, well, as much as I trust Fowler extremely well to play the puck well, he's done a great job of that so far. So a little shot like that doesn't concern me too much.
So face-off to the left of Jacob Fowler. On the face-off is Carter King. He's one of the assistant captains. He's out of Calgary, Alberta. Face-off one, Mike Posma trying to get it back for BC, but it's unfortunately won by Denver. Lemire over to the point. Back for Lemire, top of the circle. He takes a shot. Fowler steers it aside into the goal, below the goal line. BC trying to dig the puck back. Eamon Powell can't do it. It's at the point. Shai Bouyim over for his D partner. Now it's a shot. It just goes wide. That was a one-timer by, I believe that was Sam Harris, but BC gets the puck out of their zone. 14:45 to go in the first period. 3-0. Shots on goal for Denver. 0-0 is the score. Charlie Letty has the puck below the goal line for BC. He has his head up. Finds Eamon Powell. Now it's Will Smith through the neutral zone. Over for Leonard. Back for Smith. Into the offensive zone. Taken away by Denver. Ryan Leonard takes a shot. Blocked by Denver, though. That was Sebrian with the block. It's at the hash marks. Denver clears the puck out of their zone. Wright has it. Gets it over for his line mate, who is Lorenz in front. Can't find his man. It's rimmed back in by Denver. It's behind the goal line. Lorenz has it on his backhand. Looking for an option. Cycles it back for his line mate. Sebrian over to the point. Z Bouyim over to his D partner. Behrens, he rims it back in for Denver. Wright has it below the goal line. Spins off a hit for Bengtsson. Gets it in front. Denver has it at the point. Behrens keeps it in the zone. Gets it over his D partner. Bouyim takes a shot. It's blocked in front. It's in the corner. Denver still has the puck. They're really buzzing right now. Bengtsson can't clear it out for BC. Second line out there for BC still. Here is Denver. They still have the puck below the goal line. Lorenz taken away by Gustafsson and played off the glass into the neutral zone. 13:37 to go in the first period. BC has still yet to register a shot on goal in this game. See, Bouyim has the puck. He gives it away. Armstrong sends it in deep for the Eagles. Third line's looking pretty good out there for BC, guys.
Yeah, I mean, they've generated some offense, but it's really been Denver's game right now. That last shift was super dominant. They've already had some better chances than Michigan did all game.
So, yeah, that's right. Here's Hershock in the defensive zone. Backhands it. Jack Malone looking back. Gives it away. Denver has it in the slot. Save made by Fowler with the right pad. It's in the corner. Denver trying to win the puck back. Webster over for his line mate. It's at the point now. Anderson takes a shot, blocked by Armstrong. It's below the goal line again. Colby Ambrosio trying to get there first. Chips it at the point. Shot blocked by a Denver player. Armstrong going the other way now. Through the neutral zone he goes. Over for Hershock. Down the left-hand side. Back for Armstrong. Behind the back pass. Ambrosio takes a shot. And it's forward in front by Ambrosio. That get is Armstrong. He can't get it to go. So 12:47 to go here in the first period. 0-0 remains the score between Boston College and Denver. They've just registered their first shot on goal.
Yeah, good shot. Matt Davis thought that went in. He looked behind him when he couldn't feel it under his pads and looked behind. I think Matt Davis thought that one went in, the second attempt.
Yeah, fortunately, I mean, that was a great push there by the BC third line. Was able to finally get it out of our zone. Great play by Jamie Armstrong, rooming around Jack Malone on the forecheck, and they just kind of fumbled it around, and BC is able to get a quality opportunity out of usually a nothing thing. And that's another thing that separates Boston College. You're able to capitalize on those opportunities, and you know, one of those might go in. You just don't know.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, BC, they're really knocking at the door here. They've had two grade A scoring opportunities, one grade A plus, I'd say, and it averages out to about an A minus. That one was about a B. So 12:47 to go here in the first period. Denver leads the shots on goal battle 4-1 between Boston College and the Denver Pioneers. Reynolds, what are your keys to the game this afternoon for Boston College?
I think you have to be so sure and solid defensively, continuing that box that they've been doing so well earlier in the game. If they can continue that, I don't see a time where Denver scores. It's only those fluke accidents right there where you get a 1-on-0 on Fowler on the backhand. And if that's the best opportunity they're getting, I'll take that. I mean, as long as they're not getting those high-quality opportunities from the slot, I think that's what's going to beat Fowler. It's not going to be, you know, something mishmash and throw it on net. It's going to have to be a sustained offensive opportunity. And as long as BC keeps it up, I don't think that's going to happen.
Yeah, and they're showing clips now on ESPN of that earlier Denver game. And all of those goals came from sustained zone time, as we were talking, as Reynolds just mentioned. Carter King with the, I think, the dagger goal at the end came from, well, obviously a power play from a bit of a sloppy mistake on BC's part. But regardless, I think the sustained zone time is what killed BC in that game. So I think looking to avoid that would be key.
Yeah, stay out of the box. That's going to be the key for Boston College. If they take a pass, you know, that Denver power play looked pretty stagnant against Boston University. Speaking of that Denver offense, they've only scored, what is it, 6 goals throughout this whole tournament, guys?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, they've also had 2 overtime wins. I mean, they've been keeping it close, thriving, honestly, under the pressure of a close game. And if BC can jump out ahead with another grade A opportunity like they got from Andre Gasso, I think that might put Denver on their heels. And that's what the Denver we want to see. We don't want them coming back. Even though BU was able to go up quick on Denver, I mean, I still think the Eagles are a better defensive team than BU, and, you know, they get that that score they want. I mean, it could be hard for Denver to come back.
What a change it's been these past few years for Boston College. They looked pretty weak defensively the past 2 seasons, but they've looked solid this year so far. Here's Eamon Powell. He has the puck in the defensive zone after Boston College won the faceoff. Here's Fortescue. He has the puck on his stick. Looking ahead, can't find Gabe Perreault in the neutral zone. Sent in deep by Denver. It's behind the net of Fowler. He's going to tap it over for Powell. Off the glass, Gabe Perreault trying to get it. Bounces over his stick. It's still in the corner. Denver gets the puck over to the point. Behrens rims it in deep. Gets it to about the hash marks. Taken away by Gabe Perreault. Over! Will Smith! Breakaway! He shoots! Save! Made by Davis! Oh my goodness! 12-14 to go in the first period. Puck is at the blue line. Denver clears it out of their zone. Shot blocked by Will Smith. Another shot save made by Fowler. It's at the top of the circle. Bros has it. He sends it in deep for Denver. It's at the hash marks now. Rizzo across, looking for Bros, who has been the hero these past 2 overtimes. In front, Rizzo blocked in front. Drew Fortescue, what a block. Now it's Ryan Leonard in the corner. He backhands it over for Bankston. And now it is Fortescue with the puck for Boston College. Pressured by Rizzo, though. He's trying to get it in deep for Boston College. He does, and that'll be an icing with 11:39 to go in the first period. Well, these guys are pretty tired out there, guys.
Yeah, that's one thing. I mean, I'm surprised that Will Smith wasn't able to finish it. The Eagles have been so good at finishing these last few games. It seems like every single opportunity they've had, they've been able to finish. And a, you know, 1-on-0 like that seems like a prime opportunity for Will Smith to net one.
Yeah, I think Matt Davis stayed straight up and didn't commit to anything, and that's how he saved that one.
Wow. Will Smith on the breakaway gets denied by the pad of Matt Davis. And it's still a 0-0 game here. Denver wins the faceoff. They have it at the top of the circle. Looking for an option is Denver. They have to retreat into the neutral zone. However, now it's Shai Bouin. He has the puck down the right-hand side. Sends it into the corner. On the puck now is Matika. Trying to shove it in front. Fowler stands tall. Denver thinks they scored. No, they didn't. It's in front. Fowler's going to cover up with 11:18 to go in the first period. 6-1 is now the shots on goal battle between these 2 team guys.
Yeah, and a little bit of extracurriculars after the play. I think really smartly, originally Fowler was trying to get it out of the crease, but Fortescue put his stick over it and said, cover it, cover it. You can see he tells Fowler to cover it, right? You're going to see it in a second. Viewers at home, listeners aren't going to see it, but... Fortescue made an effort. Don't get it out. There's the pressure. We need a change. So I think that was part of it.
Most definitely. Cutter Gauthier's line out there for BC right now. Rieger Lorenz trying to win the faceoff. He does. It's at the top of the circle. Shai Bouyoub takes a shot. Just goes over the net. It's at the point. Played by Buckberger. Back at the point now. Shot on goal is blocked in front by Boston College. Lorenz in the corner. Loses the puck. Jakob Bengtsson has it now. Over for Gasso. And still in the BC defensive zone. Finally, BC's able to get it out of their zone. Oscar Jelvik has the puck now. Shai Bouyoub trying to force him off the puck. He's been out there for a lot for this Denver Pioneers team. It's at the point. Gustafsson rims it around for BC. Jelvik has it. Over for Gauthier. Oh, he's looking for short side. Can't find it. Now it's Jelvik. Over for Gauthier. Puck goes through his stick. Here comes Lorenz the other way for Denver. He's going to play it all the way in deep. Cross corner dump. Now it is Wright behind the goal line. Wright is looking for an option. Puck still in the corner, played by Sebrian. Denver wins the puck back again. Rizzo has it on his stick. Big hit thrown by Andre Gasso in the defensive zone. Gets the puck back for BC. Now it's Gustafsson off the boards, over for his deep partner. At this moment is Hershuk. Hershuk gets it in deep. Malone looking for a move. He has it in front, and Brozio can't find it. Hershuk takes a shot. It goes wide. It goes all the way down the ice for Boston College. Jacob Fowler is going to come out of his net to play it. What an interesting few minutes here, a few seconds for these 2 teams, guys.
BC's had great offensive opportunities. They just haven't been able to sustain it. It's everything that can go wrong. The shots are going out. They're not being able to keep the puck in.
Here's Malone. Curls into the corner. He still has it. Over for Armstrong. Good cycle by the BC forward. Armstrong over for Manetian at the center point. Manetian curls away from pressure from two Denver players and sends it in deep for Ambrosio, but Ambrosio lets it slip by him. Denver takes the puck back. Connor Joyce on the puck now for BC. Fourth line getting their first shift with 9:31 to go in the first period here. BC is looking a little scared out there, guys.
Yeah, it's like you said. I mean, Denver's been able to get sustained offensive zone time, and that's just kind of giving me heart palpitations right now.
Well, Aaron Manetian has the puck behind the net for Boston College. He's looking awfully composed in this game. Over for Connor Joyce down the right-hand side for BC. Decides to go for a cross-corner dump. Mike Posma on the puck. Throws it, and it goes. Nope, not out of play off the glass. It stays in play. And then Lucas Gustafson retreats into the neutral zone to play it for BC. Or that was actually Amon Powell. Now it's Drew Fortescue down the left-hand side. He sends one in deep for BC. And then Matt Davis is going to cover up for the Pioneers with 8:56 to go in the first period. Denver's still in front. Shots on goal, 7-1. Just about 11 minutes into this period.
Yeah, I think overall, the first like 5 or 6 minutes of this game was very heavy BC pressure. Now it's been the opposite. So, yeah, not sure what to expect. I do think it's great that Fowler's had 7 shots put up on him and saved all of them. I think it's a good start to this game. I think that BC needs to put on more pressure onto this Denver goalie, Matt Davis. I just think we need to get more shots up, more sustained zone time.
The shots that we do need to hit the net as well. It's been a lot of high into the right. Just that Hershock bomb right there. I mean, plenty of open space in the net or maybe great chance for a rebound. But if you sty it out like that and it goes all the way down to your zone, you're kind of shooting yourself in the foot. You know, sometimes it's that flashy high shot. Just get something on the ice. Get a rebound like that. I mean, that's how Denver scored on us. That was that Connor King finisher that first game. That's exactly what they did. And, you know, that's... Eagles have scored goals like that all year. I mean, yeah, it's been also those flashy plays, those Will Smith snipes. But, you know, the depth scoring is also there.
I mean, yeah, I was really liking the cross-corner dump by Connor Joyce just a few moments ago. We need more of that to kind of create that offensive zone time and kind of catch Denver on their heels, guys.
Yeah, as well, the physicality has certainly started to ramp up a bit. Oscar Jelvik on his last shift was getting pretty much locked down, just held the entire time around the net. It was still able to muster a bit of an opportunity, but I think that's something to look out on. I mean, Andre Gasso, major hit. Oh, my God. Just absolutely stood. I forget who that was. It might have been Massimo Rizzo.
It was Massimo Rizzo
right in front of the BC bench. And things like that are going to get the team, you know, ready to go.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more. I do think that this strategy of Denver moving some of their high power guys down has worked so far. I think that they've gotten decent chances on almost every line, and I actually think their best chances came from that fourth line. So I think it's, you know, something to note that, you know, David Carl's a genius. We already know that. National champion, world champion with the juniors team.
Will Smith takes a shot. Save made by Davis as the faceoff just happened. Here's Perreault into the offensive zone. He has it on his backhand looking. Shoots. Rebound in front. Boston College can't pop the rebound. Now it's Denver. They have the puck. Lucas Gustafson sends it in deep for Boston College. Nice rim. Gabe Perreault shoots one blocked by Ziv Bouyim. And then it's played by Denver. They have it in the neutral zone. In the offensive zone they go. Jakob Bengtsson does a good job playing his man into the boards. Lucas Gustafson makes a pass off the referee's skate. It ends up back on the stick of Lucas Gustafson. He has it down the left-hand side. He's looking for that cross-ice pass. Finds Gabe Perreault instead. Back for Smith. Over for Leonard. Leonard looking for an option. Has it taken away, though. And here comes Matika the other way. Taken back away by Perreault in the neutral zone. Poke forward for Will Smith into the offensive zone. They rule that an offsides with 8:08 to go in the first period. Sorry for cutting you off there, Brendan. It's just
it was
a pressing matter going on the ice.
Yeah, that was the best shift the Eagles have had all night. Absolute dominance by the freshman line right there. That's exactly what you want to see from your most talented players right now.
Yeah, I 100% agree there. 8:08 to go in this first period. Boston College is inching their way back in the shots on goal battle. They now have 4. Matt Davis really settling into this game. Will Smith just could not pot the rebound there. Cutter Gauthier wins the draw. Andre Gasso has the puck at the blue line. Can't get it in deep. You have to get it in deep there. Denver has the puck now. Into the neutral zone they go. Shai Bouyim has the puck. Over for his line mate, who is Thompson. He shoots one, it goes wide. It's at the hash marks. Collected by McCade Webster in the corner. Trying to look for the point. Oscar Jelvik takes it away. Over for Gasso. He has it. He beats the red line and sends it in deep for Boston College. Oscar Jelvik looking to get the puck back for BC. Buckberger has it now. Taken away by Gauthier. Over to the point for Fortescue. He keeps it in. Trying to send it in deep, and he succeeds. Oscar Jelvik on the forecheck. Can't get the puck back for BC. It's played off the glass. Not out of the zone as it takes an awkward bounce. Ambrosio has it in the neutral zone for BC. He's looking. He goes in himself. Looking on the backhand. Can't find anything. Hurtschuk at the point. Left point. Sends it in deep. Looking for Ambrosio. Goes over his stick and down for Armstrong at the top of the circle. Looking for Ambrosio. Finds it. Over for Ambrosio again. He rims it in deep. Looking for Jack Malone. He takes it away. Thompson digging the puck back out for the Pioneers. They can't get it out of the zone. Jack Malone across. Minetti shoots. Oh, it just goes wide. Denver on the puck now, trying to clear it out, and they do. Into the neutral zone it goes. Ira Minettian has the puck. Errant pass, though, by Minettian, taken away by Matika and sent all the way down by Denver. There they go for a line change now. Hurtschuk over for his D partner, Minettian. Off the boards, back for Hurtschuk. Off the glass, looking for Ambrosio. He finds him in the offensive zone. Ambrosio sends it in deep in his last college hockey game. Or potentially, here's Rizzo. On the backhand, skies it into the neutral zone. Hurtschuk has it in the defensive zone for BC. Curls off a hit, finds Gauthier, who's on the ice again for BC. Gauthier through the neutral zone, down the middle of the ice, cuts to the left. Still has the puck on his stick, over for Jelvik, top of the circle, across looking for Gasso. Now it's, look, Gauthier almost had his stick on it, but Bros took it away from him. It's played out into the neutral zone, collected by Minettian, then played over for Gauthier. He's gonna cross corner, dump it in for BC. BC is establishing themselves in the offensive zone here, guys.
Yeah, great shifts by the first two lines, able to get it down, and especially a great shift by that third line.
Here's Powell down the left-hand side. He's got a chance. He shoots one. And it's ramped up off the stick of Olmstad now to play with 5:52 to go in the first period. The score remains 0-0.
Yeah, as I was saying, the third line, I mean, the guy we constantly laud on the show is Colby Ambrosio. And it's not because he's putting up numbers, but because he's working his butt off every single shift. He is going there, winning the puck. He's being creative with it, and, you know, they're not generating that much offense, but Denver just absolutely looks worked when he's out there.
Yeah, he's going 1-on-4 against a lot of these lines, and he's just, like, pushing them to, like, corral him.
So, Sabrien set to take the draw against Gabe Perreault, second line out there for BC now. Referee can't drop the puck. 5:52 to go in the first period here. Face-off lost by Perreault and taken by Denver into the neutral zone it goes. They send it in deep. Jacob Fowler comes out of his net to play it. Trying to rim it around the boards is Fowler. Powell has it off the glass, gets it out of the zone for BC. Retreating is Sean Behrens. He has it on his forehand. In the defensive zone of the Denver Pioneers. Looking up, taken away by Gabe Perreault. Chip back for Fortescue. Over for his D partner, Eamon Powell. Or actually, it's Jakob Bengtsson at this moment. Played in deep by BC off the stick of Denver, so that'll be no icing. 5:20 to go in this first period. 7-4 shots on goal battle in favor of Denver. Schamberger trying to win the puck back for BC. It's in the neutral zone. Gabe Perreault has it on his stick into the offensive zone over the blue line. Looking, can't get another stick on it though, and it's played off the glass and out of the zone by Denver. Gabe Perreault is probably going to look for a change here, but he has the puck on his stick once again and sends it in deep for BC. Gentry Schamberger going to grind for that one. Sean Behrens plays it off the boards. Denver looking for an option. Can't get it in the neutral zone and establish themselves. Schamberger sends it in deep for BC. He's going to go for a change. Third line actually pops out there for BC as I fumble up with the lines. Here comes Capani. Throws it in front. Nobody home. Played off the boards. Can't get it out for BC. Shai Bouyim plays it in deep. Below the goal line, Jakob Bengtsson has it on his stick. He looks up, plays it off the boards for his D partner, Gustafsson. Over for Joyce, chipped in by Joyce, and he's going to go for a change now. Colby Ambrosio, Jack Malone on the ice now with Jamie Armstrong. Puck sent all the way down by Denver. No touch up from Lemire, so that'll be an icing with 4:13 to go in the first period.
Yeah, Denver guys were going for a change because they thought they were going to have one, but are not able to change. So we have some tired Denver guys out there. And BC is going to send the first line out, unsurprisingly. Hopefully get some quality chances right here.
Looks like Cutter Gauthier is going to take the draw. Lining up behind him is Oscar Jelvik looking to receive that pass off the faceoff and hopefully get a shot on goal for this Eagles team. Gauthier, though, loses the faceoff, and Denver has the puck, plays it off the glass. Kept in the zone by Jelvik, played off the boards. Andre Gasso, he's looking for Gauthier, can't find him. Over for Hurtschuk. Left point. Now it's Minettian in low, down low for back for Hurtschuk, center point. Now it's Minettian, center point, takes a shot. It goes into the corner. Played off the glass by Denver, played by a high stick by Boston College, and then the faceoff will come out of the zone with 3:52 to go in the first period. 0-0 remains the score.
BC's looked like the more, I think Denver is doing has a bit of a better strategy right now. They're able to get the Eagles on their back in the into the zone, but BC looks like they're outworking and has just a bit more talent, and that's what's been able to get them this, just the edge in the last few minutes. Denver hasn't got a shot on net in the last, I don't know, 10 minutes?
Yeah, it's been something like that.
Where they looked really dominant to start, but you know it's starting to swing in BC's favor, and I think that's been a trend a lot of this postseason and before that. BC's looked like the stronger team in the second and third periods. They found themselves down against Quinnipiac and was able to rally against that. You know, last night, the first period did not look that good and had two quick goals in the second period to really put them ahead of Michigan. You know, hopefully the Eagles can score and, you know, make it, you know, a little less weight on their shoulders going into the second period up one. But if not, I'm not stressing if the Eagles remain at 0-0 tonight.
Yeah, I kind of disagree. I think we need – wait, you said you're not stressing if we end at 0-0?
Yeah, in the first period.
Yeah, I would disagree. I actually think I would be stressing. I think BC does really well when they get at least one goal in the first period. I think back to games where it starts 0-0. Those are games that end up being really close. We don't always lose them, but I think obviously as a BC fan, I would like a goal.
Yeah, I mean, well, BC starts a lot of games up 1-0. I think that's a differentiating factor. Yeah. When you're the best team in the nation, you tend to score first.
To break the tie here, guys, I would say that not scoring a goal in the first period kind of plays into Denver's game in this postseason. They've only scored 6 goals in this postseason so far, so they're content to have this low-scoring game where they just clutch up. You know, Matt Davis is a really clutch goalie, so I would be a little nervous if this period ends 0-0, but I'm not really sweating that much if I'm a Boston College fan, because there's a lot of high-powered offense on both these teams.
For sure. And, you know, on the topic of Matt Davis, he's been excellent in the last 10 games. I know ESPN showed a stat where he almost had a 9-4 save percentages in the last 10 games. It's just unbelievable. 9-1 in that stretch. And you know, that's what it takes to win a national championship. And you know, Matt Davis is certainly doing that for his team right now.
Matt Davis coming into this game, 9-11 save percentage, 2.48 goals against average, which is very good for an NCAA goaltender. Jack Malone, Jamie Armstrong, and Colby Ambrosio out there for BC. Faceoff won, though, by Denver. Zeeb Bouyim has the puck on his stick. He sends it in deep for the Pioneers. It's in the corner. Fortescue plays it off the boards for Armstrong at the hash marks. He sends it back in deep to the Eagles' defensive zone. Fortescue on the puck now below the goal line. He stops up for a second. Looks into the neutral zone. Jamie Armstrong over the blue line. Plays it off the boards looking for Ambrosio. Ambrosio does a good job, but Denver's going back the other way. It could be a 3-on-2 rush taken away by Fortescue. Good play by the freshman defenseman. Fortescue over for Malone. Into the offensive zone he goes. At the top of the circle, he sends it in deep. Looking for Ambrosio. Ambrosio does have it now in the corner. On the backhand is Colby Ambrosio. Plays it over to the point for Powell. Back for Ambrosio at the blue line. Over for Powell again. Now it's Jack Malone. He can't get the puck back for BC. Now here comes Denver the other way. Into the offensive zone. Matika sends it in deep. He's going to go for a change. Next line comes out for Denver. Tristan Bros out there, along with Massimo Rizzo and Jack Devine. This is a very loaded line for this Denver team. Here's Powell into the neutral zone. Will Smith down the right-hand side. Smith looking for Perreault. Can't find it. Zach Devine trying to clear it out for Denver. Can't do it. Taken away. Ryan Leonard, top of the circle. Moves towards the hash marks. Gives it away, though. Here's Bros. Across for Devine. Down the left-hand side. Taken away by Manettian. He has it on his backhand now. Aaron Manettian curls off a hit from Devine. Plays it around the boards for Hershuck. Hershuck over for Leonard off his skate, and that'll go all the way down for an icing for this Boston College team with 2:20 to go in this first period.
It's kind of infuriating to watch. I think BC is just taking up and not taking the easy play here. They're trying to make it a bit harder on themselves, a bit more fancy, when all you need right now is a puck on the net and a chance to keep Denver down in their zone. That's when the Eagles have looked best. And they're kind of shooting themselves in the foot right now.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more. I think we're trying to get these, you know, up the gut passes across, especially the freshman line, that are just not bound to connect against a good defensive team like Denver.
2:20 to go in this first period. Faceoff won by Denver, rimmed around the boards. BC trying to get there first. Manettian one-hands it for Perreault. Perreault into the neutral zone, over for Smith, and he's going to send it in deep and go for a change. Playoff hockey being played by both these teams here. Priority one is getting fresh legs on the ice. Good poke check by Bankston. Puck goes into the crowd with 2:03 to go in the first period. 7-4 is the shots on goal battle still Not a lot of shots on goal in this period, but it makes sense as it is a national championship game.
Yeah, championship hockey. It's, I mean, this, like you said earlier, Denver's bread and butter, keeping it close so far. Only 6-4 is not a lot when you're considering it's, you know, a 4-game stretch.
Cutter Gauthier set to take the draw against Sebrian. Wins it. Bengston across for his D partner Gustafson, off the boards for Gasso. Forward for Jelvik, into the new offensive zone he goes. On the backhand, Jelvik has the puck, into the corner. Pushed off the puck by Wright. Jelvik, first endeavor for Gauthier, good save by Davis. Now Gauthier has it again at the center point, loses it. Here comes Denver the other way. Behrens has the puck on his forehand, sends it forward, looking for his man, who is Lorenz. Lorenz, taken away by Gasso, played over for Gauthier, ruled no high stick. Here comes Gauthier, looking for an option. Shoots, over the net it goes. Good shot by Gauthier there, but a good save by Davis.
Yeah, Matt Davis isn't going to let those kind of flashy shots that Cutter Gauthier can pull off against most goalies. I just don't think Matt Davis is going to let goals like that in. So I think, again, I'm really on Reynolds' side with this one. I think keeping it simple and just getting, you know, good quality shots, no matter where they come from, on net is the way to start wearing him down.
Yeah, I mean, the Eagles, that's just keep throwing them on there. It's kind of infuriating to watch.
Well, Boston College wins the faceoff. Ambrosio over for Fortescue at the left point. Fortescue looking for an option, rims it around. Armstrong first on the puck. In front, Jeff for Jack Malone. It ends up below the goal line. Couldn't muster a shot off there. It's at the hash marks. Played out by Denver. Can't get it out of their zone. Third line grinding for BC. Looking for an outlet pass is Denver. They get it out of their zone and over Fortescue. He can't make a play on it, but he has it in the BC defensive zone now. Fortescue almost gives it away into the neutral zone, sent in deep by Capone. Now, 1 minute to go in this period. 7-5 shots on goal in favor of Denver. Here's Armstrong into the new offensive zone he goes. Over for Malone. Malone loses the puck. Denver trying to clear it out of their zone. Armstrong at the blue line. Can't get it for Boston College. Bros has it now for Denver. Jack Devine out there with Bros. Sent in deep by Denver's Buckberger. Now it's Devine in the corner. Pushed off the puck by Hershock. He still has it for BC. Over for Armstrong in the slot of the defensive zone. Now it is Ambrosio. He's going to look to get it in deep for BC. Looking for a shot as Ambrosio decides just to rim it around for Will Smith. 20 seconds to go in the first period. 0-0 remains the score. Denver going the other way with the puck. Here they come. Bros drops it for Rizzo on the backhand. Rizzo shoots one. Save made by Fowler with the pad. It's in the at the hash marks for BC. Here comes Perreault with 5 seconds. Gabe Perreault makes a spin move, looking for Will Smith. 2 seconds, Smith shoots, blocked in front by Behrens. And that'll do it for the first period of action here on WZBC Newton. 0-0 remains the score. What's going on here, guys?
Some extracurriculars, and these are what I would say extended day extracurricular activities, as almost the entire team who's on the ice for both teams, Perreault got cut up with Bros and Devine.
What happened is Will Smith got cross-checked after the play a few times, just by Capone, I think it was. I'm not 100% on that one, but he was just getting cross-checked, and then Gabe Perreault took offense to that and just kind of cross-checked him in the face. Yeah, definitely under the chin right there.
So, as we hear on the PA system, 8-5, final shots, battle in that period. Well, we're going to send it into Liam, into the studio with Liam. For 5 quick minutes of music, we're gonna play some classic rock for you there. And then we're gonna be back with our intermission report for 5 minutes, and then you're gonna get another 5 minutes of music, and then we're gonna be back with the puck drop here from the XL Energy Center. You're listening to WZBC Newton. We're gonna send it back into the studio now with Liam. Thank you for listening. getting ready to come back here in 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and hello and welcome back to WZBC Newton. My name is Jacob Lassner, joined in the booth by Reynolds Johoson and Brendan Mahoney. Guys, what do you guys think of that period overall?
I think it was a really slow start by the Eagles. Denver was really dominating that first half of the period and got a lot of, you know, decent opportunities. One grade A opportunity alone in front of the net. Jacob Fowler, fortunately, was able to stop that backhand attempt. But besides that, I mean, as the game went on, the Eagles have done a great job at just eliminating those chances altogether and kind of pushing the puck more towards Denver's zone.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more. I think it's been a good back-and-forth game overall, and I think that I wonder whether or not, I guess I'll ask you guys this, do you guys think this second period is going to be more of a breakout scoring period? We're going to have a couple goals, maybe from one side or the other or both, or do you think this is going to be a grind of a game all the way through?
Yeah, I mean, just in general, I think it will. The Eagles have had a much better chance scoring in the second period in the postseason so far, and they've really been a dominant second period team. They've had three good lines of forwards they can continue to roll out, and as, even if they shorten their bench, typically those guys stay pretty on top of things.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, these guys, these are two really well-coached teams. I mean, as I look at the stat sheet here, I see that Boston College attempted 20 shots on goal during that period. But Denver blocked 8 shots in that period as a team. That's really impressive number, guys, and it's something to really take note of. Face-off battle in that period. Boston College won 5 face-offs and lost 12. Cutter Gauthier lost 5 draws and 1-2. Will Smith 0-for-4 on the draws so far, but Gabe Perreault is 1-1 on the draws so far. Him, Mike Posma, and Jack Malone are all 1-1 on their draws. So Will Smith and Cutter have to do better on faceoffs if they're going to keep themselves in this game, guys.
It's been a weakness all year for the Eagles, and it's kind of getting exposed right now. This is the one opportunity, you know, you need it for it to be better. You need that Will Smith, you know, to win more than 500% of the faceoffs. If he can get up to 500, I'll be content with that. It's just you can't let Denver just dominate possession of the puck.
Right, and Sebrian for Denver is 5-for-5 on faceoffs, and Aiden Thompson is 4-for-4. So stuff like that can't happen, especially when those guys are going up against Cutter and Gauthier. Out of those 5 faceoffs, I think Sebrian beat Cutter on 4 of them. So that's, you know, just something to point out.
Yeah, and Sebrian is their third line center, and you wouldn't really think of that third line as their best line, but honestly, it's looked like it tonight, as they have Sebrian has just been so great on those faceoffs. Another stat to note, Boston College in their defensive zone is down 3-1 in favor of Denver in terms of the faceoff battle. BC has to do a better job of winning faceoffs, not only in the offensive zone, in which they're 3-4, but in their defensive zone when they're 1-3. So they really have to do a better job of that.
Yeah, I mean, the possession thing might be the key to the game. When BC has possession, they look like a much, much better team. And it's true, they're able to kind of skate around Denver, get a possession in the other end, put some shots on net. BC's attempted 20 shots so far. Denver's only attempted 13. When the puck's in their zone, they're flying. They're getting those shots off. They're just not getting great opportunities. And, you know, it makes me upset that Andre Gasso missed his A-plus opportunity on the open net and Will Smith couldn't find a way to bury that one-on-one. But as we continue on in the second period, I mean, you got to finish on those chances and you got to be able to maintain possession after those chances as well. You can't just give up and let them go in the transition game.
I think that's happened a lot. I think we get one shot opportunity and then change immediately. Whether or not, there were a few times where we actually had what I would say would be prolonged zone possibilities that we kind of just gave up for changes after one shot.
Yeah, it's like that Aiden Hurshuck bomb from the point. You know, the Eagles are all set up in the zone. Great opportunity to get the puck on net, keep it low, but Aiden Hurshuck goes for the home run shot in the top right and it just zooms all the way around the end. And he's had a great game otherwise, you know, phenomenal defensive game. But if the Eagles can just get that offensive game going, I mean, because they've been great in the defensive end. They've really eliminated those high-quality scoring opportunities that they did a great job of the other night against Michigan. And that's a winning factor right there. And what separates the Eagles is the defensive play.
I agree with both of those takes, guys. But we're going to take a quick break here for about 5 minutes, and we're going to be back on WZBC Newton for the start of the second period. That was your intermission report. See you in 5 minutes. Getting ready to come back here. We'll give you 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Hello and welcome back to WZBC Newton. My name is Jacob Lassner. I'm joined in the booth here by Brendan Mahoney and Reynolds Johoson. Thank you, Liam Walsh in the studio, for helping us out tonight. This is Boston College versus Denver University National Championship game. The greatest stage in all of college hockey. We're back here for the second period. 0-0 game. Who will break the ice? Guys, what's going to be the key for the Eagles in this period in order to break the ice? And what's the key for Denver?
We talked about it during the intermission for Boston College, sustained offensive zone time, keeping it simple, getting those shots on that. I mean, you're going to break the goalie one way or another, and it should be, in my opinion, by sustained offensive zone skill. The finishing skill just hasn't been there tonight, so you got to rely somewhere else. For Denver, I think it's the same. It's eliminating those same zone times, keeping the transition game alive.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more. I think just getting shots up for both of these teams is the way to start.
So, Cutter Gauthier's line out there against Tristan Bros, Rizzo, and Devine. Face off, one back. Devine, over four. I believe he's looking for Bras, and then it went into the Denver bench with 19:52 to go in the second period. 0-0 remains the score. Face off in the neutral zone as the puck did not enter the offensive zone before it went out of play. Cutter Gauthier's line out there going in the opposite direction as they went last period. Bros trying to win the face off against Gauthier, who's 2-for-5 so far in the game. It's a battle for the face off. Minetian comes out with it, taken away by Rizzo. It's worked back for, I believe that's Minetian. But here comes Bros into the offensive zone. Taken off the puck by Hershuk. Now it's Minetian in the corner. Plays it off the boards for Hershuk. Now it is Gauthier trying to, but it's taken away though by Denver. And then given away, Oscar Jelvik in the neutral zone. Chips it off the boards. Gasso trying to win the race to get there. Gasso back for Jelvik, poked into the corner. Still in the corner, taken away though. And here comes Bros the other way. Bros over for Devine on the left-hand side. He's gonna try to take it all the way into the offensive zone. Sends it in deep for the Denver Pioneers. Devine trying to win the battle, can't, but it's at the point. Ziv Buyim has the puck at the point. Over for his deep partner, shot on goal! Just goes wide of the net. Fortescue trying to play it off the boards, can't get it out of the zone, shot! Save made by Fowler, and he collects the rebound. And he holds on with 18:59 to go in the second period. The score remains stagnant at 0-0.
I thought that was really sloppy from the BC defense right there. It didn't even really look like any effort was put in, and that's why a really great clap bomb from the defenseman opposite all of Ziv Buyim happened. And I just think the effort was sparse.
So Seprian, who's been amazing on faceoffs in this game so far, I don't think he's lost one, set to take the draw against Smith, wins it back. Ziv Buyim at the point. Buyim takes a shot, blocked by Leonard. Another shot taken, and it's blocked in front by a Denver stick and then cleared out of the zone by Eamon Powell. Over for Leonard down the right-hand side, takes a shot at Lasers. Out of play, over the netting. And I think that hit an unsuspecting fan in the chest, but he's gonna pick that up. It'll be a nice souvenir for his family. 18:44 to go in the second period. Shots on goal, 9-5 in favor of Denver. Face off to the left of Matt Davis, the stellar clutch goaltender of this Denver Pioneers team. Will Smith set to take the draw for Boston College. Gabe Perreault lining up beside him on the right, and Ryan Leonard to the left. Drew Fortescue at the point with Eamon Powell. Smith wins the faceoff back for Perreault. He sends it in deep. Into the corner it goes. Denver trying to clear it out of their zone. Ends up on the stick of Will Smith. Smith across. Eamon Powell shoots one. Save made by the skate of Davis. Now Leonard takes a shot and is deflected out of play once again. Not over the net this time. It gets stuck in the net. 18:28 to go in the second period. 0-0 remains the score here at the XL Energy Center.
Minor correction, that one did actually go over the net and into where the paramedics are stationed in the tunnel. So, hopefully that didn't hurt any of them, but at least they would be equipped to deal with it.
No, it's in the right above it, actually. A fan got hit by it. Usher's checking on them right now.
So, fan says that they're okay. Will Smith's line remains out there for Boston College after Will Smith won his first faceoff of the game. Aiden Thompson out of Fort Collins, Colorado, wins the faceoff back for Denver that time. Clears it out into the neutral zone. Gustafson looking for an option for BC. Sends it in deep for the Eagles. Out of his net is Davis looking for an option. Finds Ziv Buyim. Ziv finds his line mate. He has it at the top of the circle. Takes a shot right into the glove of Jacob Fowler with 18:09 to go in the second period. That's their 10th shot of the game.
Yeah, the refs. One thing that stood about this game, there's been no penalties called whatsoever. I'm not saying that there's been any blatant calls or misses, but that's just usually the refs find something to call, you know, by the 22nd minute of the game.
Yeah, I don't know. Again, I think it's like part of it's got to do with the situation, but I think part of it is that it's just been a generally clean game by both teams.
Yes, I would agree with that, Brendan. It's been a very clean game for both of these teams. 18:09 to go in the second period. 0-0 remains the score. Jack Malone's line out there for the first time this period. set to take the draw is Aiden Thompson. He's tied up. Faceoff ends up on the stick of Colby Ambrosio. He gets it over for Armstrong. Down the left-hand side he goes. Armstrong takes a shot. Blocker side. Ambrosio with the rebound into the glove of Davis. What a chance from Colby Ambrosio. The goal light flashes, but no, that is not a goal, folks. That was BC's seventh shot of the game, right into the glove of Matt Davis. Wow, what a save, guys.
I'm happy with that opportunity right there. I mean, Colby Ambrosio, quick shot up there, and that looks like it's going in if it isn't snagged by Davis. And that's the type of opportunity you want to get. I mean, now that you're in their zone, you can get some better players out there if you want. It's great.
This third line has played really well. Seriously, tremendous effort by this third line the whole game.
So, Carter King and Jack Malone facing off to the left of Davis. Malone loses that draw, and here comes Shai Buim. Over four, I believe that is Sam Harris, and he sends it in deep. Gustafson has it now for BC. Gustafson looking for Armstrong. Deflected off a stick into the offensive zone for BC. Shai Buim on the puck. Over four, Carter King trying to get it out of the zone. Can't do it. Buim back on the puck. Gets it over for his D partner, Buckberger. Into the neutral zone it goes. Played off a stick of Denver. And they're going to try and win the race, but Gustafson gets to the puck first. 17:25 to go in this period, and Denver has iced the puck, so BC's going to send out a power line here, guys.
Yeah, that's the second time BC hasn't had a great opportunity, like great back check. I mean, I think Denver should have won that. The refs have been pretty gracious giving these icings to BC, which is, you know, I shouldn't be complaining about it.
Yeah. No, but I agree. Again, if I'm a ref, I think Denver beat that out, or at least in my vision, it did.
So, Cutter Gauthier set to take the draw. He wins that one for a change, but it's a missed drop by the referee. I mean, almost every game, we get a lot of these missed drops by referees. I'm just wondering what they're seeing to blow the whistle dead after the drop of the puck.
A lot of encroachment.
I see. So, Gauthier again, set to take the draw against Carter King. He wins it back. Shai Buim. Buim, off the boards. Trying to get it out of the zone. It's Denver. They do. Sent all the way down. Hershuk. Rims it around. Looking for Jelvik. Goes through his skates, but he's still on the puck. Jelvik over for Gasso. Nice transition through his legs. Gasso looking for something. Shai Buim pushes him off the puck. 2-on-1 for Denver. Taken back by BC. Here comes Minetti into the offensive zone. One hands it over for Gauthier. Now it's Gasso. Goes through his stick. Denver going the other way. Taken back away by Gasso. He works it back. Hershuk looking for Gauthier. It's on his stick now. Forward for Jelvik. Taken away, though, by Buim. Shot by Gauthier off the side of the net. Now it's Gauthier. He collects at the hash marks, looking for the point. Man, who is Minettian, but then it's sent all the way back down as it was out of reach of Aaron Minettian. Minettian collects on the backhand, moves it on the forehand for Hershuk. Off the boards. Finds Leonard down the right-hand side. Into the offensive zone. Ryan Leonard looking for an option. Leonard shoots one into the chest of Davis. That's BC's eighth shot of the game. 16:29 to go in the second period. 0-0 remains the score.
I'm really happy with the opportunities. This is exactly what Reynolds was talking about, and I think that, again, these aren't shots that are destined to go in, but they're shots nonetheless, and I think warm us up and maybe get Matt Davis a little bit looser.
So Will Smith, Ryan Leonard, Gabe Perreault out there now. Smith trying to win his second faceoff of the night. He's got three shots on goal so far in this game. It goes through the legs of Powell and into the offensive zone. Right on the puck for Denver. Fortescue takes it away from him. Gets it out of the zone. Gabe Perreault can't get his stick on it. He could have had a 2-on-1 rush there. Instead, it's Sean Behrens. He has it at the top of the circle. Moves in, takes a shot. Save made by Fowler with the pad. Zee Buim in deep. Finds right. Who shoots one. Save again by Fowler. Played off the boards by Powell. Can't get it out of the zone is Ryan Leonard. He's being held by a Pioneer player, and then he floats the puck all the way down the ice. That'll be an icing. Guys, what'd you see on that play? What happened?
Frustration from Ryan Leonard. He was getting hooked pretty badly there, held by a Denver player, and the ref's just kind of looking at him. It might have been a bad angle, and the ref couldn't see it, but Ryan Leonard just kind of iced that out of frustration. He's still kind of looking back at the ref, just to get any kind of, you know, clarity on what the ref was thinking.
Yeah, again, frustration is the thing that we just have to avoid, and frustration is the reason we lost that first Denver game.
So, 12-8, shots on goal battle, faceoff one back by Boston College. Fortescue over four. Perreault down the left-hand side, he has the puck on his stick. He's pushed into the boards. Head first by a Denver player, he's going to go to the bench for a change as his stick went out of his hands, and then Denver is going to almost ice the puck, but Fowler decides to play it. Powell has the puck in the defensive zone, taken away by Denver. Here they come now. Webster pushed into the boards by a BC player, and that'll be a penalty. And maybe more.
Yeah, that could definitely be five. Mike Posma was that just bad hit as the trainer goes to try to collect him.
So that's something you don't want to see if you're a Boston College fan. With 15:29 to go in the second period, we'll see what the referee says here. So 2 minutes for boarding is the call. The precedent has been set by the Boston University game to not give out major penalties for boarding, as there was a major penalty. Looks like they might take a look at it. But
they should. I do think he kind of turns into that at the last second, but Mike Posma is going in there really low and just catches him the wrong way. I don't think it was something vicious, but the game has definitely gotten more physical as it goes on.
So the Denver player is able to be helped up. That was Webster, the captain of his team out of St. Louis, Missouri. He's a seventh round pick of the Tampa Bay Lightning. Crowd reacts now. He's been a breakout star for this team. Florida Panthers found a gem. He only had 19 points in his freshman year, and now he's one of the leaders of this team.
Yeah, I'm going to agree with Reynolds on this one. As much as I don't want to see it, I think that might be a major. The replay looks really bad.
Well, the Denver coach, David Carl, signaling to the referee now. They're having a conversation over at the bench. I'm not sure if he's going to challenge.
Yeah.
And Denver has challenged.
Oh.
No, they have not challenged the ruling. My apologies
Wow. There.
They're going to let it play out. 2 minutes on the clock for the penalty assessed to Mike Posma. Carl says, I don't even want to bother this time, as he challenged it against Boston University. It's at the point. Behrens across. And a good play by Armstrong to get the puck out of the zone for BC, but Denver's going to collect in their own zone. Behrens stills the puck for the Pioneers through the middle of the ice. Drops it back for Rizzo. He gets it over for Thompson, sends it across. And it's across. Thompson has it on his stick. Thompson looking for an option, finds Behrens. Behrens stops up at the bottom of the circle, finds Rizzo at the left point. Now it's Behrens, top of the circle again. Behrens moves down low, feeds it back for Rizzo at the point, at the left point specifically. Now it is Denver again. Rizzo behind the back pass, over for Behrens, down low for Thompson, at the bottom of the circle to the left of Jacob Fowler. Now it's at the center point. Behrens has it again. Rizzo, top of the left circle, in front, shot, save made by Fowler with the pad on the shot by Jack Devine. Now it's Armstrong. He can't get it out for BC. Denver keeps it in. They play it to the other side of the ice. Minetian trying to win the race to get there. He can't do it. But kept it by Denver. Rizzo just narrowly, or that was actually King, narrowly could not keep the puck in the zone. But Denver's going to go right back with it. Thompson trying to find Devine. Taken away by Minetian and sent all the way down the length of the ice. BC's going to have to go for a change really quickly here, guys.
Yeah, great kill so far by BC.
40 seconds to go on the kill for Boston College. 14:06 to go in the period. King has the puck on his stick at the left point. King sends it in deep. Taken away by Hurtschuk. It's in the slot. Played out to the point. Zeev Bouyam has the puck now at the right point. Bouyam down low. It's in front. So, my gosh, what a block by Boston College. And then it's cleared out of the zone. 20 seconds to go on the kill. 13:46 to go in the second period. 13-8, the shots on goal battle. Zeev Bouyam has the puck for Denver. Bouyam works the puck up the ice. Matika has it. He's pushed out of the ice by Bankston. And then it's sent all the way down the length of the ice by BC. 4 seconds to go on the kills. 3 seconds and two. That'll do it for the kill. What a kill by the Boston College Eagles. 13:27 to go in the second period. 0-0 remains the score here at the XL Energy Center. Drew Fortescue can't get the puck back for BC. It's in the corner. Denver trying to do something with it. Taken away by BC. Here they come the other way. Jack Malone, or Cutter Gauthier, has it down the left-hand side over for Perreault. Perreault can't find a stick on it. Taken away by Denver. They're going to go the other way now. It's in the neutral zone. Trying to be poked away by Gustafson. Taken away, though, and played into the neutral zone. Sent into the glove of Fowler by Denver. Good job by the BC netminder to really pay attention there. It's played over for Gauthier in the neutral zone. Gauthier drops it. Perreault, 2-on-2 rush, and it's taken away by Anderson. It's played in front. Leonard can't get a stick on it. Gustafson with a pinch to keep the puck in the zone for BC. And then it's played out into the neutral zone over the glove of the outfielder, Aaron Minetti. And here comes Sebrian. He has it below the goal line. He plays it in front. Shot just goes wide for Denver. It's at the point. BC trying to win the puck back. Ryan Leonard expressing some frustration over there. Then it's played all the way down by Denver. Will that be an icing? Yes, it will. 12:24 to go in the second period. Denver has iced the puck. 0-0 remains the score.
Yeah, absolutely textbook kill by BC. That's really been the strength this year, of one of the many strengths of this team. Textbook kill overall, and beautiful block by Aiden Hershak. He and Lucas Gustafson have been, you know, real staples in this defensive time for BC.
So 12:24 to go in the second period, 0-0 remains the score. Will Smith's line out there. Oh, Will Smith actually out there with Colby Ambrosio and Oscar Jelvik. Interesting line decision from Greg Brown, but I like to see it. Bankston over for Manettian. He moves back into the defensive zone for Boston College. Manettian moving past two Denver players. Down the right-hand side, sends it in deep for the Eagles. Coming out of his net to play it is Davis. He rims it around the boards. It ends up going past the stick of Bankston. Boston College got to hurry on this icing, and Manetti narrowly beats his man out to win the race. 12 minutes to go in the second period.
Again, that was sloppy going for the icing. I just think that like the effort is turned off on a lot of these plays that are usually where BC excels, is those hustle plays. And I think Reynolds pointed out earlier too, but again, just the slow skating for the icing. Fowler's like, hurry up. Fowler waves his glove, hurry up.
So 12 minutes to go in the second period, 13-8 in favor of Denver is the shots on goal battle. Faceoff one back, Gustafson can't get it in deep for BC, taken away though by Denver. It's in the neutral zone. Armstrong wins the puck back for BC. Puck eludes everyone and goes all the way back. Gustafson on the puck. He sends a cross ice pass for Armstrong, who can't get a stick on it. Here comes Lemire over for Anderson. He's going to send it in deep for Denver. No icing as it went off a stick. Almost pops in front, but Fowler's able to hold on with 11:37 to go in the second period. We're going to send it back to Liam Walsh in the studio for a quick 2 minute and 30 second break.
Getting ready to come back here. We'll give you 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Hello and welcome back to WZBC Newton. 11:37 to go in this second period. The score remains at 0-0. Reynolds is testing out his singing voice here in the booth.
No singing voice, Jake. No idea what you're talking about.
So what do we think? Better or worse than Jacob Fowler?
Better.
Yeah,
better at singing.
The bar is very low.
Better at singing, worse at playing goalie. Well, face off to the right of Jacob Fowler, as we were just talking about him. Jack Malone set to take the draw for BC. Define, Bros, and Rizzo out there for Denver. Now let's talk about Massimo Rizzo for a second. He was on the team when Denver won the national championship in Boston 2 years ago. So he's a very veteran presence on this team. He was a seventh round pick. Face off though, won by Boston College. Here they come. Manetti can't get it out of the zone. Devine keeps it in, but then Gauthier lays a big hit on it. Here comes BC the other way. Andre Gasso trying to win the race to get there. Beck Renz does though. He gets it out of their zone. It's trying to be sent in deep by BC, but it'll be offsides and no whistle because Denver was the first one to touch the puck. Here's Beck Renz. He has the puck on his stick. Plays it off the stick of Devine and in the offensive zone. Fowler comes out of his net to play it. Aaron Minetian behind the goal line. Rims it around for Gauthier. Down the right-hand side over for Minetian. He gives it away. Bros has it on his stick. He sends it in deep for Denver. Fowler comes out of his net to play it. 10:57 to go in the second period. 0-0 remains the score. Gauthier plays it across. Now it's Oscar Jelvik. Into the offensive zone he goes. He has it. Plays it in front. Gasso shoots one. Save me. Rebound. Gauthier just goes wide. It's behind the net of Davis. It's at the point. Minetian looking for a shot. Decides to rim it around. Oscar Jelvik has it in the corner. Jelvik has his head up in the offensive zone looking for an option. Drops it back. Eamon Powell. He shoots one. Save made by Davis. Wow. Great shift from BC there. That's their 10th or 11th shot of the game. 10:28 to go in this second period, guys.
Yeah, and if you're going to call it both ways. That's how I feel. I think after the play, Oscar Jelvik is tied up and held and has his stick thrown from him. You see it right at the end there. And I think if you're going to call a minor one way, call it the other way too.
Yeah, but I mean, minors and penalties aside, that was a perfect shift from Boston College. Sustained offense presser, great, great, great opportunities, and hopefully the freshman on the line can carry that on.
100%. Will Smith on the draw for BC. He's taking the draw against Denver's Sebrian, who's been great on faceoff. Sebrian wins that one. Denver breaks it out. Into the neutral zone it goes. Here they come. It's Lorenz over for his line mate. They score! Denver breaks the ice in this game with 10:18 to go in the second period. 1-0 is now the score here at the XL Energy Center.
That shot slips right by Fowler, just under his blocker's side. I mean, it went in, it didn't go in initially, then it comes, kind of bounces right back in, and just an unlucky, unlucky bounce, just zero angle shot off the back of Fowler and in the net.
So 10:18 to go in the second period. Boston College has a mountain to climb here of a 1-0 deficit against this Denver Pioneers team that does not let up goals very often. That's just an unfortunate goal. It hits off of Fowler, bounces over Fowler, and then goes into the net for Denver. That was Wright on the goal, I believe. So Jared Wright breaks the ice here for Denver. Sebrian set to take the draw against Jack Malone. He wins it back. Buckberger has the puck. He plays it off the boards. On the puck now is Lucas Gustafson. Trying to play it, gives it away. Here comes Denver. Wright shoots one. Save. It goes over the net. Now it's at the point. Buckberger. He plays it over to his line mate. It's Wright. He shoots one. It's blocked in front. Jack Malone trying to get there first. It ends up on the stick of a Denver player. Pushed aside by Fowler. Bengston. Over for Armstrong, he backhands it back to Gustafson in the defensive zone. Gustafson over for Ambrosio, he sends it in deep for BC. BC's in need of a push here, guys. Denver has the puck in their defensive zone, taken away by BC. Malone plays it across. Fortescue shoots in front. Ambrosio looking for a stick, can't get it on there. Here's Malone, curling at the hash marks, sends it in deep for BC. Armstrong now on the puck for the Eagles. He sends it to the point. Fortescue takes a shot, it goes wide. Now it's Powell pinching in the offensive zone. Eamon Powell plays it in front, taken away by Denver. Thompson. Now it's Denver again. King, he has the puck on his stick, plays it across. Thompson, he has it on his stick, looking for the wraparound, can't do it. Ambrosio playing good defense on him. Decides to make a pass. Webster, top of the circle, shoots. That one goes wide. Denver still has the puck. Behrens chips it in deep for the Pioneers. Fortescue has the puck on his stick, plays it off the boards, looking for Ambrosio. Ambrosio out of gas. Zibuyam makes a pass, makes a play around Ambrosio. Cutter Gauthier and Andre Gasso hop on the ice for BC. Shot on goal, save made by Fowler. 8:50 to go in the second period. Boston College trails Denver 1-0 in the game and 16-10 in favor of the shots on goal battle.
Denver has had a full head of steam after that goal. They've just been flying all around the ice and great opportunities left and right. The Eagles had one or two great, grade A opportunities in front of the net. Pass across center to Colby Ambrosio in front of the net. Wide opens happen. Tied up with the stick coming across. Doesn't get anything on that. And Denver just capitalizes on the chances that they've been given right now. It feels like after that shot, Denver is just a threat from anywhere.
Yeah. The energy's been sucked out of the BC crowd. Denver's kind of overpowering it now. But again, like, I just think we need to stay focused. I think everyone needs to understand that it's one goal, and that, again, this team hasn't been down much this season, and that was kind of the same worry that I had with the Quinnipiac game, is that this team's not used to playing from behind, so I think that again, hopefully that Quinnipiac game was a good preparation for something like this.
So Denver up 1-0 in this game, 8:50 to go in the second period. They have 16 shots on goal to BC's 10. And an unfortunate start for this Eagles team, but they're a very high-powered offense, and just one bounce needs to go their way in order for them to score. But on the other hand, Matt Davis has looked fantastic tonight, guys.
Yeah, he's been on top of his game. The Eagles haven't had any spectacular scoring opportunities where they had a great opportunity to beat him. But on the shots that they've taken, I mean, he's been robotic in that, able to just kind of eat everything up.
Yeah, couldn't agree more.
So, 8:50 to go in the second period. Once again, Denver up 1-0. We'll have a face-off to the right of Jacob Fowler, referee, waiting eagerly for Boston College to get on the ice. Second line pops out for Greg Brown and his squad.
I just hope this TV timeout, you know, Coach Brown is able to get some fire back into this Eagles engine.
100% Reynolds. Well, on the draw is Carter King, assistant captain out of Calgary, Alberta. King loses out on the draw. Lucas Gustafson has the puck for BC. He plays it off the boards. Perreault can't get it on his stick, and then it's sent all the way down by Zeev Bouyum. Fowler comes out of his net to play it. Bankston has the puck for BC behind the goal line. He has his head up, looking for an option. Is Jakob Bankston. He decides to skate out with it himself. Bankston over for Smith, goes through his legs and all the way down the ice. That'll be an icing for Boston College.
It's got to get a stick on that. Good job by Jacob Benson just to get the puck going around, get the defender chasing him. 4-on-5 for the Eagles going the other way. But just nothing out of it. Will Smith, unfortunate, got to pick his head up, and now the Eagles are going to eat one in the defensive end.
So Denver remains up 1-0, 8:28 to go in the second period now. BC trying to amount to something in this period. Smith wins the draw once again. Gustafson has it on his stick. He has a lot of space, decides to make a pass for Ryan Leonard. Ryan Leonard tripped up on the play. That'll be no call and no icing. Zeev Bouyum plays it into the neutral zone. Jakob Bengtsson has to retreat into the defensive zone and feed it over for Gabe Perreault. Perreault over for Smith. Down the right-hand side of the offensive zone, finds Leonard on the other side of the ice. Ryan Leonard has it taken away by Denver. Behrens has it on his stick. 3-on-3 rush the other way. Behrens has it on the forehand. Looking for an option, decides to just throw it into the corner, where Gustafson's going to rim it all the way down for Boston College. That'll be another icing for this team. A lot of icings in this game. That's been one of the stories, guys.
It's tie wearing the Eagles down right now. You could look at Ryan Leonard, just looks so shaken up, so tired. And I think Denver's going to have a great A opportunity right here.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more. I think overall, part of the icing is just sloppy effort at the end. But I think part of it's sloppy effort at the beginning, just throwing pucks down out of frustration.
So, 7:52 to go in the second period here. Face-off one back. On the stick of Buckberger. He's looking for an option. Finds his deep partner, shot on goal, blocked in front by Gustafson and played out of the zone by Boston College. Will Smith's line looking to get off the ice here. Sebrian has it taken away. Smith plays it into the offensive zone and all the way down for Boston College. He's going to go for a change now, I believe. Fourth line pops out for BC. This is Mike Posma's first game time since the penalty that he took earlier in the period. Minetti over for his deep partner. Hershuck down the left-hand side, finds Posma. He sends it in deep for BC. Posma looking to lay a hit on a Denver player. It's at the point now. Minettian chips it back in. Connor Joyce, he plays it around. Minettian, Hershuck over for Schamberger at the point. Taken away by Denver. Breakaway. Here they come. Lorenz has it. He shoots. Save made by Fowler to keep the puck out of the zone. Out of the net for Boston College. And then BC plays it over the glass and out of play with 6:58 to go in the second period.
I don't think Gentry Schamberger is going to another shift after this. That was a brutal turnover, something you cannot do right now, and it's not a great back check from him either. That's embarrassing. You got to pick it up after that. You got to come out, and this rest of the shift for him has to be grade A, or else he's probably going to ride the pine.
So Mike Posma set to take the draw for BC. Fourth line remains out there for the Eagles. Taking the draw is Aiden Thompson, third round pick of Chicago. Face off won by Denver, just goes wide of the net. Hershuck over for Schamberger, looking to make up for his mistake. Schamberger falls to the ice. Zeev Bouyum has the puck now. It's in the neutral zone. Webster has it on his stick. He shoots when it goes wide. On the puck now is Batika. He sends it around. Webster on the puck now. Over for Bouillon at the point. Zeev Bouillon down low for Webster. Now it is Matika. He still has it on his stick. Makes a pass down low for his line mate. Matika takes a shot. One-timer blocked in front. Manetian has the puck on his stick now. He plays it over. Connor Joyce can't get to the puck, though. He's going to go for a change. Fourth line remains out there. Behrens has it on his stick. On the forehand is Behrens. He can't move around Hershuk. Behrens still has it, though. He's dragged down to the ice by Hershuk. And then it's taken away, though, by Schamberger. Now it's Jelvi. He can't get it for Gasso. Rizzo has the puck on his stick for Denver. He makes a move past Gasso. Into the offensive zone, met by a hit. But here comes Thompson. He shoots one. Save made by Felder. Once again, he's able to hold on. With 5:57 to go in the second period.
All I have to say is that Fowler shouldn't be put in the position that he has to keep making saves like this. I think it's just sloppy defensive work by BC, and honestly, sloppy offensive work to turn over into bad defensive possessions for BC.
Fowler just looks angry right now. That was one thing I noticed. His expression was that of frustration. He's had two one-on-ohs just in the last minute or two, and that's just due to two Eagle turnovers right and giving Denver grade A opportunities.
Definitely, guys. 5:57 to go in this second period. Denver up 1-0. Boston College wins the faceoff back. Here they come. Gasso down the right-hand side, plays it off the boards. Oscar Jelvig trying to be the first one there. Shai Bouillon has the puck. He plays it on the backhand. Over for King. Now it is Devine into the neutral zone. He's going to skate it in and play it all the way down for Denver. Fowler comes out of his net to play it. Fowler. He gives the puck away. Cutter trying to win the puck back for BC. Behind the BC net, plays it over for Jelvik. Jelvik can't get it out of the zone. Now it's Gauthier. He can't get it out of the zone. Kept in, though, by, I believe that is Bros, and played all the way down, but BC finally able to get the puck out of their zone. It's Powell down the right-hand side. He plays it all the way in deep for the Eagles. Cutter Gauthier on the puck. Trying to find Gasso, but he's going for a change. Here's a two-on-two rush. Mental mistake by the Eagles. Here's Bros. He shoots one. It goes wide. Eagles falling all over the place here, not looking their best, but BC still has a chance in this game. It's taken away in the neutral zone. Lorenz has the puck on his stick. Lorenz makes a pass over for his line mate, who is right, who's the goal scorer in this game. Jelvik then clears it out of the zone for BC. Gauthier is going to go for a change here. Zeev Bouillon has the puck on his stick for Denver. Bouillon down the left-hand side into the offensive zone. Makes a pass. Good play, and they score! Riker Lorenz scores his 16th goal of the season. He's a Minnesota second-round pick. Guys, what do you think about that play?
Beautiful shot by Riker Lorenz right at the dot of the circle. That's the exact same spot where the last goal was scored, too. He's got 2 points right now. Just beautiful shot right above the blocker. Fowler just left out to dry tonight. It's embarrassing. Eagles really need to pick it up, and hopefully Coach Greg Brown can inspire the Eagles to do better.
4:44 to go in this second period. 2-0 is the score in favor of the Denver Pioneers. BC looking to regain themselves here on this next shift. They're going to elect send Ryan Leonard, Gabe Pro, and Will Smith out there. The best line in the entire country. To kind of regain the momentum back for the Boston College Eagles. Face-off won by BC. Charlie Letty has it in the defensive zone. He plays it over for Bankston. Over for Leonard, still in the defensive zone. Ryan Leonard with the puck on his stick. Over for Letty. Letty shoots, save made by Davis, into the corner it goes. Zeev Bouillon gives the puck away. Will Smith has it on his stick. Smith off the boards looking for Perreault, he gives it away. Behrens going the other way. Down the left-hand side for Denver. He takes a shot, Fowler steers it aside. On the rebound is BC. Ryan Leonard has it in the corner. He has his head up in the defensive zone. Curls up, dodges a hit from a Denver player, plays it for Smith in the neutral zone. Will Smith across, Gabe Perreault has a chance. On the backhand, moves to the forehand, can't get a stick on it. Will Smith over to the point. Bankston takes a shot, blocked by Leonard in front. And then into the glove of Davis. A lot of shoving going on behind the play here, guys. What's going on out there?
It's frustration. It's like, you know, as much as you want calls there, it's like when you're clearly frustrated and you're inciting and instigating, you're not going to get calls for anything. You're just not.
Yeah, Denver took offense to Gabe Perreault kind of driving the net there and ended up kind of taking out Gavis. And then that's going to be Boston Buckberger who just takes out Perreault. And Ryan Leonard, being the feisty, you know, driven player he is, just goes over there and wants to start some trouble. It's just got to capitalize on the opportunity. You got to speak with your actions, not with just, you know, trying to get some frustration out at the end of the play.
So BC trails Denver by a score of 2-0. Rieger Lorenz scored that goal. He is a Minnesota Wild draft pick, second round pick. He's taken a huge step since getting to Denver. He had 9 points in 37 games as a freshman and much more this year. He's listed at 6'3", and he's from Calgary, Alberta.
Yeah. BC needs to have something happen here. Coach Brown needs to inspire the Eagles to do better. They've looked really sloppy at some points, and that's what's going to cost them the game at this rate. And they haven't been able to capitalize on the other end either.
Yeah, I had a little bit of loss for words, and I think a big part of it is effort, and it's, you know, you got to show up.
In the national championship game, Brendan.
You got to show up and give your full effort.
100%. Boston College looks a little scared out there. No, everybody's scared to make a play for this Eagles team. They've got to act, and they've got to act fast. They cannot get to the locker room soon enough, but again, time is ticking in this game, guys.
Time is certainly ticking. The Eagles only have about 24 minutes to mount a comeback, which is plenty of time, and we've seen at the rate the Eagles can score. Just yesterday, 2 goals in 1 minute alone at 4-on-4. The Eagles really would like a penalty or power play here. That's what's going to would spark a lot of offense, you know, maybe get them something going, but it's just frustrating to watch.
So Boston College is a face-off in the offensive zone. Andre Gasso with Cutter Gauthier to his left behind him. Looking for that shot off the face-off. Gustafson and Powell out there for BC. Gauthier wins the draw back for BC. Gasso wins it. Gauthier takes a shot. It goes wide into the corner. It goes. Denver is first on the puck. He's knocked down by Eamon Powell. Puck still remains in the corner, below a Denver player. Oscar Jelvik has it at the point. Over for Gauthier at the top of the circle. He takes a shot. Doesn't go. On net. Oscar Jelvik at the hash marks. Looking to dig the puck back for BC. Gauthier sends it all the way around. Andre Gasso on the puck now for BC. Gasso still has it. Shoots one. It goes wide. Gauthier. Oh, looking for the wraparound. Can't finish. Then played off the glass and out of the zone by Denver, but that'll be an icing.
That's the type of shift you want right there, Jacob. Beautiful play. That's, you know, feistiness, the driven. And Oscar Jelvik hasn't been a player who's let that get to him, and I think a lot of that just his driving ability into the corner. Andre Gasso and Cutter Gauthier, just really Herculean efforts to try to get something going right there. And hopefully the freshman Jan follows up with something good right now.
Yeah. Will Smith, Ryan Leonard, Gabe Perreault out there for BC. Smith set to take the draw against Sabrian. Well, face-off one back by Denver. It's in the corner. Will Smith trying to get the puck back for BC. It's in his skates, taken away, though, by Sabrian. And then trying to be played out of the zone. Sabrian has the puck on his stick once again, plays it off the boards and out of the zone. Minetian curls away from the pressure, plays it over for Perreault, taken away. Here comes Wright, one of the goal scorers for Denver. Now it's Minetian. He has the puck in the neutral zone. Over for Leonard into the offensive zone. Rims it around. Gabe Perreault trying to get there first. It's at the point. Aaron Minetian plays it. Or Hershuk plays it over for Minetian. Top of the circle. Minetian in the offensive zone. Taken away, though, by Massimo Rizzo. And then played over for Bros. Bros has it on his backhand of the offensive zone for Denver. He plays it. Shot! Save made by Fowler into the glove with 2:40 to go in the second period. That's Denver's 20th shot on goal. BC is lagging behind with 11.
That was a great effort by Will Smith just to get anything on that shot to stop that wide open attempt in the slot. BC needs to also muster some shots here. It's important, and you know, laugh shifts were great, but if you can get some sustained offensive zone time from one of your top lines, and the second line, the freshman line, they just haven't been up to standard right now.
Jack Malone, Jamie Armstrong, Colby Ambrosio, Eamon Powell, and Drew Fortescue out there for BC. Jack Devine has the puck. He takes a shot. It's blocked by Fortescue. Now it's Powell in the defensive zone. Gets it over for Ambrosio. Loses out on the puck. Denver plays it into their offensive zone. Drew Fortescue backtracks over for Powell. 2:26 to go in the second period. BC needs a goal fast. Here's Malone into the offensive zone. He shoots one. Just goes wide of the net. Fortescue hops off the ice. Here comes Denver the other way. Thompson has it on his stick. Curls away from a hit. Gets it over for Devine. Devine below the goal line. Gets it back for Thompson at the hash marks. Thompson still has the puck at the point. Sends it in deep. Taken away by BC. And played for Armstrong. Taken away again, though, by Denver and played into their offensive zone. Jacob Fowler comes out of his net to play it with 1:56 to go in the second period. Over for Armstrong. Armstrong brings the puck behind the goal line over for Gustafson. He's going to stop up behind the net of Fowler for a second. 1:45 to go in the second period. First line out there for BC now. Gauthier, Gasso, and Jelvik. Played in deep by BC off the stick of Oscar Jelvik. No icing is the call. Jelvik wins the battle against Shea Bouillon. Played off the referee by Gauthier. Here comes Denver the other way. Unfortunate bounce. Looking for a breakaway was Denver, but played into the corner instead. Gustafson trying to dig the puck out for BC along with Gauthier. He pokes it over for Bankston. Now it's Gasso. Hits out of reach for him. Jelvik works for the puck back for BC. 1:10 to go in the second period here. Gustafson has it in the defensive zone. Over for Jelvik. He skies it into the offensive zone. 1 minute to go in this period. Here comes Bros into the off, or King into the offensive zone. He's going to float one in with 55 to go in the second period. Denver still remains up 2-0. It's taken away by Denver again. Zeev Bouillon has it in the neutral zone. He's looking for an option. 45 seconds to go. BC is looking like they just want to skate nonchalantly to the end of this period. Here's Behrens, has the puck on his forehand. Looking in front, just goes over the stick of Sabrian. Here comes BC the other way. Will Smith down the left-hand side. Smith curls away from a hit, looking for an option. Makes a move. He still has the puck on his stick. At the hash marks, 26 seconds to go in the period. Leonard shoots one into the glove of Davis. You're going to need a little more than that, guys.
Yeah, sustained zone time, that's not sustained if you just kind of shoot at the first opportunity you're given. I know I'm preaching them to keep it simple, but if you take a wind-up for a shot in the middle of the net, no one there to screen it or block it, when you can move it around a bit more for another 22 seconds, I think you're passing up on golden opportunities. BC has to fix something during the intermission and hopefully get something going in the second or third.
Yeah. Again, I don't hate that shot, but I agree. I think it would be better if we took a little bit more time before taking a shot.
So second line remains out there for BC. Gabe Perreault set to take the draw. Will Smith waits for him on his left, right behind him. Face off, one back. Will Smith has it at the point, trying to make a move. He's pushed off the puck. Here comes Denver the other way. It could be a 2-on-1 if they hurry. Devine plays it in deep. Sabrian trying to get there. He's knocked down by Gustafson. Then he rolls into Fowler. BC is not liking that, but he was tripped up by a BC player. 13 seconds to go in this period. Denver's veteranship is showing here in this period, guys. It looks like they've been here before and BC hasn't. What does Greg Brown need to say in the locker room in order to get into these guys' heads and be like, hey guys, it's time to wake up?
I don't know. There's a lot of maturity on the team, and you've seen how much they matured over the course of the year. So, this is the same exact Denver team they played and they lost to. They know exactly what they have to do to beat them, and they know exactly what they did to lose to them. It's the frustration that's getting to them now that caused them to lose in that game, like third game of the year.
Well, Tristan Bros taking the draw for Denver against Cutter Gauthier. Gauthier loses the draw, still in the defensive zone for BC, chipped out by Malone, or Gasso, and it's in the neutral zone, 4 seconds to go in the second period, and that'll just about do it for the period here. 2-0 is the score in favor of Denver. Guys, BC's got a really tall mountain to climb here in the second period, but we're gonna discuss that in about 5 minutes. We're gonna send it into the studio with Liam Walsh for 5 short minutes of music, then we're gonna do 5 minutes of intermission report, and then we're going to send it back for 5 minutes of music, and then the puck drop for the third period where BC has a tough, tough, tough mountain to climb. My name is Jacob Lassner, joined alongside by Reynolds Johoson and Brendan Mahoney. You're listening to WZBC Newton, sending it back into the studio with Liam Walsh now. getting ready to come back in 5, 4, 3, 2. Hello and welcome back to WZBC Newton. My name is Jacob Lassner, joined alongside by Reynolds Johoson and Brandon Mahoney. Boston College currently trails 2-0 against the Denver Pioneers in this national championship game. Guys, what the heck happened in that period? Was that the Eagles that we're used to seeing?
Yes and no, I think. In the usual sense, yes. I think Denver exposed a lot of our weaknesses and was able to kind of capitalize on sloppy play and frustration. It was something that has not really plagued the Eagles, but has come out on occasions. But one thing that I would like to just kind of invoke with that as well is that sometimes that does result in the Eagles giving a Herculean effort to come back. You look at the Quinnipiac game a few weeks ago, and I also think of the Beanpot, where BC played maybe their best period of the entire year and just couldn't get by BU. I'm hoping that comes back, and you know, BC's able just to fly by, but Denver's doing all the right things that BC did against Michigan. They're keeping the pucks to the outside. They're not letting BC get a lot of high-quality chances, especially in that second period. And it's just super frustrating to watch.
Yeah, I completely agree. Interesting stat to note is that in 6 out of the past 7 games, BC has scored 3 goals in the third period. And they're going to need something like that if they want to win this game. So, you know, only time will tell, but it's not looking great.
Still plenty of time to score. I mean, BC is one of the most electric teams in college hockey, if not the most electric team in college hockey. And I also, I mean, there is some championship experience on the team. Not in the same way that maybe Denver has, where they've won a national championship, but earlier this year, BC winning the International Junior Tournament. You have Jamie Armstrong, who played at BU last year. You know, played. He knows what it feels like to lose, and hopefully he can tell these Eagles guys how much it sucks and how much they need to get their stuff together and carry on into the third.
Yeah, I agree with both those takes, guys. I mean, there's plenty of time left in this game. Now let's go through the stats from that last period. Boston College took one penalty in that period. It was assessed to Mike Posma. It was a 2-minute boarding penalty on him. So Boston College has taken the only penalty in this game. Shots by period. Denver University, 13 shots on goal. Boston College, 7. Boston College has a total of 12 shots on goal. Denver has a total of 21. 2 goals were scored in that period. First one by Jared Wright. Assisting on that one was Rieger Lorenz and Shai Buyum. And then Lorenz scored. Buyum had the assist. And Sean Behrens had another assist on that one. So, and also face-off battles for both these teams. Denver had 7 blocked shots. Denver had a few blocked shots in that period. Boston College won 12 face-offs. Denver won 15 in that period. So a bit of a bit better period in terms of face-offs. But that's about it for Boston College.
Yeah, that's kind of it. Fowler's still playing incredible, in my opinion. That second Rieger Lorenz shot was an absolute rocket, and I think anyone would have trouble stopping that. It's just BC has to get some opportunities and has to get back to themselves against Michigan. They were so calm, so cool, so collected, and I think some BC players have still maintained that kind of philosophy. I was mentioning Oscar Jelvik earlier. He's been great. He's still giving 100% each and every shift, and unless he's, you know, I don't know, Swedes are kind of infamous for that stoicism. And hopefully you can kind of project that onto the other players as well. Jakob Bengtsson, maybe a bit more effort, you know, a bit less stoicism out of him. Kind of beat on a few icings there. But as far as individual efforts go, I think it's that second line that really needs to pick it up. They're the odd guys who are going to be able to score here. They're the talented guys. You know, when they're working hard, they're drawing penalties. They're getting grade A opportunities, and they're burying goals. And that's exactly what the Eagles are needing right now. They need those guys, the versions of them that were drafted, you know, 4th, 9th, and 23rd overall.
Yeah, I mean, they're going to have to skate faster when the puck is not on their sticks, is Boston College. They're going to need to put in 100% effort. They're going to need to put in that Oscar Jelvik effort at all times and when everyone is out there for Boston College, because the effort has just not been there, especially in that last period. But I would even say in the first period, too, it was kind of the same story for BC. They're not normally a team that gets outshot by 9 shots on goal, so they're going to have to establish themselves in the offensive zone.
Yep.
And really get to work So we'll be back in 5 short minutes, or around 5 short minutes, for the start of the third period. There is a lot riding on this period for Boston College. Anyway, we're going to send it into the studio with Liam Walsh. We're getting ready to come back here, Liam. 8-7-6-5-4-3-2. Hello and welcome back to WZBC Newton. My name is Jacob Lassner. I'm joined alongside by Reynolds Johoson and Brendan Mahoney. If you missed it, during our intermission report, we said that BC just was not giving 100% in terms of effort, or at least maybe they think they are, but there's another gear that they can kick it into, right, Reynolds?
Yeah, BC has this, I think, another whole entire gear. You saw it last game against Michigan, that second period, that 4-on-4 stretch, where they just seem unstoppable. And if they can reach that gear, kind of put it into another thing, I don't know what they have to do to unlock that gear. And hopefully Greg Brown has the key to that answer and was able to, you know, fix it in the locker room. But they need to help Fowler out more. I think that starts with just better defense. You need to kind of emulate that Michigan play and just get back to the transition game a bit more and get it back into their zone. You can't let Denver just dominate in our zone.
So more established zone time is going to be the key to this period for the Eagles. We were talking. Oh, it looks like Greg Brown has made a line change here, moving Oscar Jelvik down to the second line. Ryan Leonard now playing with Cutter Gauthier and Andre Gasso. Greg Brown didn't really like what he saw from that second line. So, faceoff won by BC, set all the way down, chipped over the shoulder of Reynolds and Leonard, and all the way down for Denver. Boston College collects in their own zone. Here's Minetia, over for Gasso, down the left-hand side. Gasso, with his head up, takes a shot, rebound! Gauthier can't finish. Now it's Leonard. He has the puck in the offensive zone, taken away by Denver. They still have it in their defensive zone. Aiden Hurtschuk plays it between his legs over for Gauthier. He sends it in deep for the Boston College Eagles. Out of his net to play it is Davis. He plays it over for his D-man. And then it's sent all the way down off the stick of Lorenz. Fortescue behind the net of Fowler, looking to dig the puck back for BC. Lorenz takes it away from him. And then Will Smith now has it for BC. Smith plays it off the skate of Jelvik, and then it's played all the way back down by Denver. It's rimmed around. Oscar Jelvik has the puck for BC. Over for Perreault. 2-on-3 rush for the Eagles. Perreault sends it in deep for the Eagles. He has the puck. Looking for Jelvik. Just goes over his stick and out of the zone. 18:53 to go in the second period. Powell over for Fortescue. Now it's Perreault. He directs the puck in deep for the Eagles. Davis comes out of his net to play it. Jelvik almost finds Perreault with the open net as Davis was out of the net. But here comes Denver the other way. Webster, he has the puck at around the red line. Bengston gets it back for BC. Now it's Perreault. He plays it over for Smith. BC has drawn a penalty. So they'll go to the power play here. With 18:31 to go in the third period, Boston College goes to the power play. Not sure what the call is.
It's going to be a hook, Jacob. Yeah. Cade Webster is getting around the arm of Jakob Bengstrom, holding him up, preventing it from moving the play forward. And that's pretty classic textbook call for the referees.
100%. So 18:31 to go in the third period. 2-0 is the score. BC heads to the power play.
Yeah, if anything's going to bring back this Boston College Eagles team, it's the electric factory that is the Boston College power play. If anything's going to get them back in this game, it's that.
Yeah, I mean, these guys are all A1. All these guys are going to be in the NHL sooner or later. They have to capitalize now.
So 18:31 to go in this third period. Cutter Gauthier, Gabe Perreault, Will Smith, and Eamon Powell, Ryan Leonard out there for BC. Pap, here comes Smith. He has it at the left point for Boston College. Sends it in deep. Perreault, top of the circle. Down low. Leonard trying to force his way in front. Covered up by Davis. A good veteran play by the goaltender to locate the puck and get his glove on it with 18:22 to go in the period. 1:51 to go on the power play.
Yeah, smart play by Leonard. I like that at the goal line, trying to draw the defender from the other side. Maybe look at something backdoor. And even after that, maturity just to walk away from, you know, the confrontation from the net. Obviously a little cross-check first, but you know, he's gonna walk away from that, and that's a smart play.
So Boston College loses the faceoff in the offensive zone. Denver has it behind their own net. Shai Bouyum, he's gonna send it the length of the ice for this Denver penalty kill. 1:40 to go on the power play for Boston College. Eamon Powell has it. He has it taken away by Denver. Sent all the way down again. Eamon Powell has to regroup. Good play by Jared Wright, one of the goal scorers. He's an LA Kings draft pick, round 6. Gabe Perreault has it in the neutral zone. Sends it back for Ryan Leonard. He still has it. Taken away, though, by Denver. And now it's Gauthier in the neutral zone. Down the left-hand side goes Cutter Gauthier. He has the puck on his stick. Moves towards the middle. Plays it. Leonard just has it handcuffed off his stick. And then he's thrown down to the ice behind the goal. He's going to have to go pick up his stick. Here's Powell. Shot, Gauthier blocked in front. Rebound, another try by Gauthier. It's blocked in front again. Will Smith trying to force it in front. Leonard Smith, what a save! What a save by Matt Davis! 17:22 to go in the third period, and Boston College almost buried one, but Matt Davis got across with the glove and the blocker to keep it out for Denver. Oh my goodness! 17:10 to go in this period. Boston College has 37 seconds of power play time to work with. Here comes Smith down the right-hand side. Plays it. Gives it away. Denver plays it out of the zone. Gustafson out of his street back. He's in a race. Capani is there first. He shoots one. Save Fowler. Bengston on the rebound. Over for Malone. Down the right-hand side he goes. He sends it in deep for BC. Andre Gasso is there. Now it's Gustafson. He chips it forward. Jack Malone over for Gustafson. He's looking for a play. Can't find Gasso in front. Chipped away by Denver. Bengston keeps it in at the right point. Over for Jelvik at the left point. Oscar Jelvik. Down low. sends it across. Gustafson at the top of the circle. Now it's Jack Malone. Penalties killed by Denver. Gasso trying to dig for the rebound. He can't get there. Webster on the puck now. And here's Bros. He has the puck in the deep neutral zone. Sends it in deep for Denver. Wow, what did you see on that save, guys? I mean, oh my goodness.
Just incredible, Jacob. The way he just sprawled across and had to save that sure goal, it reminded me of the beanpot save by Jacob Fowler with the glove. I mean, that's exactly what you're looking at.
So, Davis. Thank you, Davis Chance, erupting in the Denver section here in the XL Energy Center. Here's Hershuk. He flubs a pass. Bros takes it away. Sent in deep by Denver. 2-0 still remains the score. 15:45 to go in the second period. Here's Bengston behind his own net, looking for an option. Over to Posma. Now it's Armstrong, taken away by Denver again. They're going to be content to send it in deep. Massimo Rizzo, met by a hit from Hershuk, sends it in deep with one hand. Aaron Minetian has the puck for Boston College, moves his way into the neutral zone, has it on his backhand, sends it in deep for Denver, for Boston College. Davis comes out of his net and plays it to his defenseman. It's in the neutral zone. Can't be played away by Will Smith. Still in the neutral zone, and then played in deep by Denver. 15:11 to go in this third period. Hershuk over for Smith. Drops it off. Perreault into the middle of the ice. Into the offensive zone. Perreault shoots. Blocked. Rebound. Perreault looking for five hole. Can't stuff it in. Will Smith on the backhand. Takes a fall to the ice. Minetian keeps it in for BC. Then it's taken away by Denver. Played into the neutral zone by Denver. Will Smith can't get it back. Still in the BC defensive zone now. Perreault looking for Smith on the pass. Just goes over the past the stick of Will Smith and all the way down for an icing for Boston College with 14:48 to go in this period.
Again, this is the best effort that BC has given, and it's still not producing goals, and I think it's tough. But again, I think we've put up how many shots at the beginning of this period. I thought the effort's definitely there. Matt Davis with the save of his life. Wow.
That's the best save I've ever seen.
Pushed off so far on that left leg to sprawl airborne. Oh my, yeah.
That's the best save I've ever seen. Well, Will Smith set to take the draw. He gets tied up. Now it's Perreault over for Jelvik. He has it. Skate to stick transition into the offensive zone. Chips it off the glass. Gabe Perreault trying to get there. Shai Bouyam has the puck. Clears it into the middle of the ice. Taken away. Will Smith over for Gauthier. Or that was Powell over for Gauthier. But nonetheless, Denver has the puck. Now it's Powell over for Jelvik down the right-hand side. Drops it back. Gauthier back for Jelvik into the corner. In front. Dropped. Powell looking for a pass. Poked away by Denver. Ryan Leonard at the point. Over for Gauthier. Down low, it's Jelvik. Now it's at the point again. Eamon Powell has it. Down low for Gauthier. Now it's Fortescue. Left point. Gasso at the slot. Shoots one. Blocked in front by Denver and then cleared into their own bench by Sebrian. With 14:04 to go in the third period. Guys.
BC certainly has picked it up, and they're looking pretty good coming out of the intermission, but like Brendan said earlier, it just hasn't been enough. I mean, the Davis is save of a lifetime. I mean, absolutely going airborne, sprawl. I mean, you can see him just kind of crouch up and launch over and just to get the glove on it, and it's just a miraculous job on his part. And they're showing the Gasso miss earlier just to emulate.
That's the two
luck,
goals that Boston College should have had tonight, Reynolds.
Yeah, it's they just haven't been able to finish something they've been able to. They're a finishing team. They've been able to finish so well, and that's what they did perfectly against Michigan. But tonight, it's going the other way. Goaltending has been through the roof for Denver, and the Eagles haven't been able to bury one. But the Eagles keep it up the way they've been playing. They're going to score.
Yeah, it's only a matter of time. I think shots are going to fall. They just got to keep it up.
So again, 14:04 to go in the third period here. Boston College winning the shots on goal battle in this period. 4-1 so far. 22 shots on goal total for the Denver University Pioneers. And 16 for Boston College. They're going to need some more in order to tie up this game. It's 2-0 in favor of Denver. Matt Davis making the best save that we've ever seen here at the XL Energy Center, where Boston College trails 2-0. Well, BC is going to need a hope and a prayer here to come back in this game.
I mean, they've got the talent. I know they have the talent. We've seen it all year long, where their star players have been able to score, and even their depth players have been able to make miraculous efforts at result goals. I mean, I'm getting flashbacks of Oscar Jelvik being able to shovel it point blank into the net, or just Andre Gasso's or Rocket shot. One of those things just has to happen. One thing just has to fall BC's way, and I know they'll be able to claw back from this.
Well, Jack Malone set to take the draw against Tristan Groves for Denver. He's got Kapani to his right. Malone loses that draw. Denver has it in their defensive zone. Kapani trying to get to the puck. Bengston gets there first. Gets it over for Gustafson. Tracks back into his defensive zone. Plays it for Malone, who then gives it away to Denver. It's played in deep by Denver. Bengston is there to receive it for BC. Gustafson plays it off the boards and all the way down. That'll be an icing. Colby Ambrosio beats it out. It's in the corner. Ambrosio trying to fish the puck out. Zeke Bouyam makes a nice play for Denver to start up that breakout. They send it in and over the glass. So that'll be out of play. Faceoff where, guys? Where do you think the faceoff is going to be?
I think the neutral zone.
In the neutral zone. So Boston College gets a bounce there. And they'll have a faceoff in the neutral zone to recoup. 13:28 to go in this third period. Ryan Leonard, Cutter Gauthier, and Andre Gasso hop out onto the ice for BC with 13:28 to go in this period. Gauthier ties up his man on the draw, wins it back. Hershuck over for Minetian. Minetian for Gauthier. Chipped into the offensive zone for BC. And then a high stick by Boston College, but no call on the play. Bit of a miscall there by the referee. Here's Hershuck, center point. Over for Gasso. At the faceoff dot, shoots one. Save made by Davis. Hershuck over for Leonard. Just escapes his grasp. He's at the blue line. Chipped away by Devine. And Leonard's going to have to play it all the way back in the defensive zone. He's building up speed. He's pressured by Devine. Leonard into the offensive zone. He shoots one into the glove of Davis. Davis is the star of the show right now. This goaltender is 100% locked in for this Denver University Pioneers team.
Yeah, BC isn't going to beat him stationary right now. Andre Gasso just wasn't able to exploit that weakness. And he's got an absolute rocket of a shot, and we've seen it before. But if he can just maybe get Davis to move a little bit, a little shimmy or anything, just square up to him and shoot it right in the chest, that's not going to get the Eagles anywhere.
Well, Will Smith, Jelvik, and Perreault out there for BC. Smith's got to win this faceoff here. To the left of Matt Davis. Smith wins the faceoff back for Powell, escapes his grasp into the neutral zone, it trickles. 12:44 to go in this period. Fortescue over for Perreault, back for Fortescue, over the red line. Gives it away. Sebrian has the puck on his stick, makes a pass, shot, save made by Fowler. Sebrian trying to play it back into the offensive zone, still has it on his stick. Sebrian forces his way in front, pushed off the puck by Powell. Now it's Smith. Looking for Jelvik. Skate to stick transition through the middle of the ice goes Oscar Jelvik down the right-hand side in the offensive zone. Down low, below the goal line is the puck. Gabe Perreault and Oscar Jelvik. Smith digs it out, gets it over for Gustafson. Gustafson at the point, moves towards the center point. He's looking, shoots off the post! And then it trickles all the way down. Boston College cannot buy anything right now. 11:58 to go in this second period. Denver still remains up 2-0.
Oscar Jelvik was getting it in the corner. No call.
Shai Bouyam has the puck for Denver. Plays it off the boards. Into the neutral zone it goes. Played in deep. McCade Webster has it on his stick. Down the left-hand side. Plays it through the stick of his line mate. Now it's below the goal line. Bengston pushes his man off the puck. BC coming the other way now. Lucas Gustafson down the left-hand side. Makes a play. Throws it all the way down for BC. Shai Bouyam plays it out of the zone for Denver. 11:25 to go in the third period. 2-0 is the score in favor of Denver. Played off the boards. They have it in the offensive zone. Matika looking for a shot. Blocked in front by Gustafson. Puck lays there in the slot. Gustafson looking to clear it. He still has it on his stick. Plays it off the glass and out of the zone. Fourth line still out there for BC. Jack Malone hops out with Colby Ambrosio. So third line out there for BC. Ambrosio wins the puck back for BC. Sends it in deep. Jack Malone trying to get there. Malone. Zeev Bouyam has the puck. He makes a nice play and gets it out of the zone for Denver. Here they come in the neutral zone. A good play to get it in deep by Denver. It is the third period. Rizzo in front. It's in the slot. Taken away. Zeev Bouyam has it. Center point. Looking for an option. Feeds it down low for Denver. 10:37 to go in this third period. It's in front. What a save by Fowler. 10:33 to go in this period. It's in the neutral zone now. Denver has it. They're going to backtrack into their defensive zone. Bouillon plays it over for Behrens. Now it is Devine down the right-hand side for Denver. Pushed off the puck. Nope. Devine still has it on his stick. Good play by Devine. Forces it in front. Taken away by Ryan Leonard. Leonard still has it on his stick. Poked away, though, by Bros. But then it's played all the way down by Gauthier. Shai Bouillon plays it over for Devine. Now it's Fortescue. Ryan Leonard down the right-hand side. Takes a shot into the chest area of Davis. 10 minutes to go in this third period. 24-19, shots on goal battle. 2-0 is the score in this third period.
Hopefully this offensive zone draw will enable BC to get some more offense. That was, I wouldn't say it was bad play, but they allowed Denver just to kind of dominate it in their own zone for a second. And it wasn't great opportunities. They had one good shot that Fowler luckily was able to get out to the side. Rebound control was excellent today. But it's just the Eagles need to get something going. They can't be content just to play okay in the transition game.
Since March 1st, Matt Davis has a .935 save percentage. BC wins the draw, shot on goal, saved by Davis. Rebound collected. Will Smith takes a shot through the middle of the ice. That one goes wide. Eamon Powell has it in the corner, trying to be pushed off the puck by Lorenz. Jelvik has it on his stick, looking for an option. He still has it at the hash marks. With his head up, Jelvik looking for Pro, taken away by Denver. Kept into the zone, though, by... Nope, never mind. Offsides called on the play. 9:35 to go in this third period.
That was close. I don't know if he got it in, but maybe. It's too close for that. Eagles need to get something going. That was a great shift, but Oscar Jelvik needs to be a bit more careful with what he does with the puck there. I mean, as the trophy comes up on the screen, that's what these players should all be thinking about right now. That next ship, how are they going to enable BC to win the national championship right now? And Denver's thinking the same thing. How can we hold on? How can we make sure BC doesn't get that A game that we're so afraid of? And for them, that's staying out of the box. BC has another look on the power play. I doubt they'll miss again.
Yeah, I completely agree.
I don't think BC's going to get another look on the power play. Referees have given them two chances here, guys. But if they do get another chance, I do see that happening. You're right. 9:35 to go in this third period. Brendan, what do you think BC has to do here?
Again, I think kind of just doing what they did on that last shift. And again, like you said, I think Matt Davis really, really is good when he's stationary and doesn't have to move. So I think getting him moving a little bit is something that BC really has to do if they want to win this game.
Most definitely. He's looked great, though, Matt Davis. I mean, he is just a guy who's locked in since March 1st. He's got a .935 save percentage, and I don't think he's lost a lot of games during that stretch either.
He's lost one game in the last 10.
Wow.
Yeah, I mean, but the Eagles are going back. They're undefeated 14 games. These are two hockey giants right now battling it out for the most coveted trophy in college hockey. And right now, Denver's the better team. It's going 50-50. But Denver got those two quick goals and just put them on top, and they're pretty content just to play a much more defensive game and let BC just kind of work themselves to death.
So, face off in the neutral zone. Boston College sending out Cutter Gauthier, Andre Gasso, and Ryan Leonard to take this draw for the Eagles. Fortescue and Powell out there as well. All right, fakes off one by Denver. It's in their defensive zone. Behrens has it on his backhand, sends it over for shot. Save made by Fowler off the stick of Ziv Bouillon.
Like you said earlier, Jacob, the clock is ticking. 9 minutes and 27 seconds to go in the third period before Denver is awarded, you know, hockey, the trophy. It's the Eagles have to pick it up right now. This is do or die. This is your season right now. And I think some Eagles players have realized that, and some haven't.
Face-off in the face-off dot drop. Cutter Gauthier wins it. Powell has it in the defensive zone. Over for Fortescue, down the left-hand side. Finds Gasso. He's going to chip it in, deep for the Eagles. Davis rims it around the boards, goes over the stick of Gasso. It's going to go all the way down the ice, but it's ruled an icing as Fortescue gets there first. A lot of weak icing calls in this game, guys.
Yeah, I don't know if that one touched Andre Gasso's stick or anything. It looks like he might have was in a good position to stop it. But you know what? Denver's a bit more tired now. You're getting fresh legs out there. This is a perfect opportunity to capitalize. 9 minutes and 8 seconds left. Eagles need to get one going now.
Gabe Perreault set to take the draw. Will Smith lined up behind him to the left. Face-off is to the right of Matt Davis. Shots on goal, 25-20 in favor of Denver. BC inching closer in that battle. Looking for them to score a goal here. 9:08 to go.
Looked over to Carl to call the timeout, and Carl said no. Just something to note.
Well, Perreault wins the faceoff. Will Smith shoots one right into the breadbasket of Matt Davis, into the chest area to be specific. 9:06 to go now. Good shot by Will Smith, but Matt Davis is up to the task and more. So again, we'll have a faceoff to the right of Davis, who's been the hero for Denver by all stretches of the imagination here. Face-off, controlled by Denver. Played in deep, though, by Boston College. Gabe Perreault trying to get there. Zeev Bouyam plays it off the boards. Gustafson can't win it back for BC. Rimmed all the way and out of the zone by Boston College themselves. Eamon Powell's going to have to go back into his defensive zone to get the puck. Over for Jelvik. Jelvik back for Powell below the goal line. He's going to send it over to Gustafson. Gustafson looking for Perreault, can't find him. Now it's Jelvik. Taps it over for Perreault and into the bench of Denver. 8:40 to go in this third period. Clock is still ticking, Reynolds.
I don't even know what to say. I mean, the Eagles, they know what they have to do. They haven't been able to do it. They've given Matt Davis, 51 minutes and 20 seconds of just, shooting it into his chest, giving him easy shots. He's only had to make about, five, six hard saves today.
Yeah, if that. I think Matt Davis hasn't been challenged much at all.
Well, here's Aiden Hershock at the left point. He's going to try to chip it in deep for BC, and then Gauthier decides to chip it in himself, but it goes right into the glove of Matt Davis as it caroms off the boards and into the glove.
Yeah, I mean, Denver's pretty content right here to take every single whistle they can. That's just more time. They can be well-rested. They're taking as much time as they can on the change, just getting their guys out there. And you're not letting BC get any momentum with the calls. I mean, they have to get that sustained momentum where the legs are tired, the shots are going around, and Davis is just content to freeze every single thing that comes his way. BC is not going to be able to get that opportunity, Jacob.
So, Cutter Gauthier is out there with Jack Malone and, I believe,
Colby Ambrosio.
Good job by Greg Brown to really move these lines around. Missed drop by the referee, Sabrian, was a little early on that one. 2-0 remains the score in this third period. 8:27 to go in this game. Gauthier wins it back. Manetian at the left point. Takes a shot, it goes wide. Aiden Hershock has it now. He backhands it in deep. Colby Ambrosio plays it with one hand on a stick. Jack Malone trying to win the puck back for BC, along with Cutter Gauthier and Aaron Manetian. It's chipped out of the zone, though, by Denver. Hershock has to retreat back. He has it on his forehand, plays it, gets caught in the referee's skates. Aaron Manetian in the BC defensive zone. He has the puck on his stick. Plays it back. Colby Ambrosio hit to the head on Minetti, and BC will go to the power play with 7:55 to go in this period. What do you think about that call, guys?
Weak call, but I'll take it every single time.
Yeah, I agree. Bad call, but I'll take it.
I understand what the Denver fans are booing here. That's a really weak trip to call right now when so much is on the line for Denver. And if I'm a Denver fan, I am livid at that call.
Yep.
But as a Boston College fan, you got to take every single opportunity you are gifted right now. I mean, just
they have to score here. No option.
I guess. I mean, they caught him with the leg, but it's technically right. Wrong. It's the national championship. You shouldn't be calling stuff like that.
Yeah, I agree. That's quite a bad call. But again, BC needs anything they can get right now.
So 7:54 to go in this third period. BC trails Denver 2-0. Third period of action here at Xcel Energy Center. Sabrian and Gauthier set to take the draw here to the right of Matt Davis. Gauthier wins it. Smith, left point. Perreault, top of the left circle. He's trying to send it across for Gauthier. Good play by Denver to keep it out of harm's way. Powell over for Smith at the top of the left circle. He's looking for Leonard in front. Ends up on the stick of Gauthier at the hash marks. Now it's Powell at the center point. Powell over for Gauthier at the top of the right circle. Finds Smith, taps it. Perreault makes a nice move. Makes it. Leonard in the slot. Gauthier shoots one, blocked in front by Sabrian. Now it's Powell curling at the hash marks for Boston College. Eamon Powell looking for... That is actually Perreault. He sends it over the stick of Gauthier and all the way down. 1:24 to go in this period. 7:16, or 1:20 to go in this power play. 7:11 to go in the period. Here's Smith, shoots off the blocker of Matt Davis. Will Smith at the hash marks, looking for an option. Finds Gauthier at the top of the right circle. Down low for Gabe Perreault. Now it's Leonard. He shoots one right into the chest of Matt Davis. 1:05 to go on this power play. 6:59 to go in the period.
Matt Davis is making every single save. Obviously, those aren't hard saves to make, but he's really standing on his head.
You mean, at this point, you think, beautiful shot by Ryan Leonard. I mean, an inch to the right. It's just like each one of these shots is just, I don't know the luck factor. I don't know if there's a stat for luck, but BC, it's not them today. That shot placement, everything. It's just everything is going Denver's way, and Matt Davis is standing on his head playing the game of his life.
So, face-off won by Denver. Gasso sends it over for Gustafson. Now it's Bankston at the center point. Sends it for Jelvik at the left hash marks. Over back for Bankston. Now it is Bankston at the center point. Looking. Jelvik, top of the left circle. Shoots one. Just goes wide. Now it's Gustafson. Over for Bankston at the center point. Across. Jelvik, top of the left circle. Across. Gustafson shoots one. Matt Davis is up to the task. And then it's sent all the way down with 40 seconds to go on this power play. 6:31 to go in this third period. Tick, tick, tick goes the clock. Here's Jelvik in the neutral zone. Has his head up looking for an option. Finds Ryan Leonard. Looking back for Jelvik is Leonard. Can't get it to him. Puck sits behind the goal line. Denver clears it out to the point. Bankston keeps it in for BC. It's at the point. Jack Malone across. Shot! Save made by Matt Davis on Gauthier's one-timer. 6 minutes to go in this period. 10 seconds to go on the power play. Gauthier has it at the hash marks. Over for Bankston at the center point. Gauthier at the top of the right circle. Puck goes over his stick. A lot of bodies on the ice here. That'll do it for the power play. Denver sends it all the way down the length of the ice. Jack Devine comes flying out of the penalty box. Ryan Leonard has it for BC. Leonard, with 5:40 to go in this game, has it on his stick. Ryan Leonard makes a move. Still has it on his stick into the offensive zone. Leonard trying to find Hershuck. Over for Smith through his legs. What a play by Rizzo and Devine to deflect that puck away. And Minetian can't keep it in for BC. 5:25 to go in the third period. Clock is ticking still. Rizzo met by a hit from Hershuck. Still gets it into the offensive zone. It's played in deep by Denver. It's Batika. Now it is Minetian over for Hershuck below the goal line for Boston College. Now it's Perreault. 5:05 to go in this third period. Perreault over for Minetian. He sends it in deep for the Eagles. Matt Davis comes out of his net to play it. Shai Bouyam over for his D partner. They're going to skate with it. Hershuck is there to meet the puck in the neutral zone. He sends it all the way down. Matt Davis on the puck. Davis plays it off the boards. It's at the point. Hershuck can't keep it in for BC. It's played out of the zone by Denver and sent all the way down. 4:37 to go in this game.
BC looks really tired right now, Jacob.
Hershuck has the puck on his stick. Plays it over for Jack Malone through the neutral zone to the offensive zone he goes. Malone into the corner. He still has the puck on his stick. Looking for an option. Jack Malone plays it over for Armstrong. Jamie Armstrong shoved off the puck by Shai Bouyam. Now it's at the point. Gustafson looking for an option. On goal. Save made by Davis. And he's going to hold on once again with 4:11 to go in this period. And in the game.
At Jacob. What point do you pull Jacob Fowler?
Yeah, I was just about to say, my eyes are on Jacob Fowler right now.
I don't know, but it might be early, but the puck just keeps bouncing over people like Cutter's stick. It's just tough.
So tough. I mean, Denver is playing so well defensively right now, but BC isn't exactly helping them do so well right now either. I mean, BC's making them not have so hard saves. I mean, a few of those were great A opportunities. I really like the Cutter one-timer. I really like Jack Malone's shot on that. There's some great passes there, some great redirects. But Denver's really keeping them to the outside. They're not getting that high danger zone that we've seen BC have so much success in during the season. Just the slot area, between the dots. I mean, those guys are snipers. And, you know, it's Davis is 26 for 26 on a team that's shooting like 15, 16% on the year.
Right.
It's so impressive right now. He's been playing the game of his life, and he's the reason Denver's going to win this game at this rate.
I wonder, do you pull Fowler right now?
No, too early.
I mean, Rand Pecknold pulled Peretz last year with the 3:36 mark, and they were only down one goal. So,
well,
I don't know.
I don't know either.
I think you could see it at any time. I'm of the opinion the sooner the better.
Yeah.
BC's so dominant on the power play, and Denver wasn't able to get any opportunities out of that. I mean, yeah, it's not a 5-on-4, it's a 6-on-5, but BC steals the opportunity and the advantage in that situation.
So 4:11 to go in this game here. Denver is up 2-0 on Boston College. Shots are 14-4 in favor of Denver, or in favor of Boston College in this period. They've really mustered everything they can on BC. But it's just been a tough game for the Eagles all around.
Yep.
Tough third period, a tough second period leads to a third period of desperation, and so far it just has not been enough. Matt Davis is a brick wall, pitching a shutout for this Denver team.
I just hope the Eagles drop his save percentage right now and put up three quick goals or something. I mean, It's crunch time. It's been crunch time for the last 15 minutes, and
yeah,
now it's more than that.
It's way more. It's past crunch time for Boston College. Cutter Gauthier, Andre Gasso, and Oscar Jelvik out there right now. Denver fans are bumping in the XL Energy Center as they're just 4 minutes and 11 seconds away from a national championship. BC wins the faceoff. Gasso takes the shot. Rebound. Save. Jelvik on the rebound. What a save by Davis. He keeps it out once again for the Denver Pioneers. Oh, my goodness. Matt Davis, you are a brick wall.
Yeah, Matt Davis is going to get a nice contract after this game. Davis has played so well. Davis is an undrafted free agent, so I think we'll see Matt Davis in the NHL pretty soon after this performance.
Elite edge work today. I mean, just able to push all the way across the net. I mean, that's one of the keys. BC had to get a movie. They're getting him moving, and he's just unable to respond so well. It's so tough to watch.
Absolutely, Reynolds. 16-4 shots on goal in the period for Boston College. That might have been their third best chance of the game right there. Whoa, where's the puck there? I don't know what happened on that faceoff, but the referee blows the whistle. 4:01 to go in this game.
Just shot off right out. Cutter tried to push it forward almost with a shot and just went right into the upright.
Just keep shooting is the motto for this Boston College team as they are struggling to stay afloat in this game. The ship is sinking. Here's Behrens, over for Ziv Buyum. Plays it into the neutral zone. Oscar Jelvik trying to play it in deep for BC. It ends up covered up by Matt Davis once again. And that's such an, you know, it's a strategy that I really don't see that much. A guy like Matt Davis, his number one priority is to stop the play. He's done it so many times in this game.
Like I said, Jacob, it's stopping all the Eagles' momentum they can muster. I mean, if he keeps the play, he gets those Eagles coming down, bearing on those Denver players. I mean, he's just keeping the game in his hands. He's trying to control it, and he's the man right now. He's why Denver is going to win if they keep up.
So Denver plays it off the glass. Manetian saves it at the blue line. Rims it in. Gabe Perreault can't get the puck. Now it's Will Smith up top. Bankston, center point. Manetian, right point. Over for Bankston at the left. He shoots one. It goes over the net. Perreault trying to stuff it in. What a play by Denver to keep it out of the net. Now it's Smith at the right point. Makes a nice move. Gets around two Denver players. Keeps the puck in. 3:25 to go. Takes a shot. Save made by Davis. Rebound. Played by Bankston. It sits in front. BC can't get a stick on it. Played out of the zone by Denver. Here they come. On a one-on-one break. Shot off by Kapani. Blocked by Fowler. Now here comes Smith. 3:09 to go in this game. Sends it in deep for the Eagles. Jacob Fowler still stays stationary in his net. Denver plays it out of their zone. 3 minutes to go in this game. And that'll be and offsides on Denver. 2:59 to go in this third period, and Denver is really playing a fantastic third period here. I mean, they've kept the score at the same score this whole period, even though that BC has really, really tried and tried to kind of break through to the other side.
It feels like exactly, this is how much Michigan fans must have felt like 2 days ago. It's, you know, you're getting so many good shots on goal, or not, I mean, not even good shots, but just shots on goal, which are, okay, Greg Brown timeout.
I like that.
Yep. Give your best guys some rest. Have them coming out flying. That's, they're so good. They're so good when they need to be. They're on fire. And in order for them to win this game, they need those guys to show up right now. You know, it's two goals, and, you know, 3 minutes, very much doable with this team. I believe in them. I believe in their ability to score on command. And they just need to find what it is that, you know, enables them to do that. This is the greatest stage in college hockey, and, you know, this might be the only time the Eagles get here in a really long time. You know, you want to do it for your seniors. You want to do it for Eamon Powell. You want to do it for anyone who's going on to the NHL next year who won't have an opportunity to do this again. They have so much riding on this, and, you know, it's been a turnaround season from the Eagles. I know they'll be back here, but it would be so good, so amazing just to come back now, channel everything, give it every last drop, and just pull away with this one. But Denver's just too good, and off Matt Davis, I mean, he's just spectacular.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more. Very inspirational speech from Reynolds right there. I hope Greg Brown is saying something similar. And it looks like, I think as soon as BC gets into the offensive zone, Fowler will be gone.
Yeah.
That's my guess. But
most definitely.
There are the Williams, Zeev and Shai's parents.
Oh, that's nice. Fun fact about their parents. They moved to the United States as adults to give their kids a better life. They're from Israel. Face off in the neutral zone. One back by Denver. On the puck is Buckberger. He sends it in deep. Jacob Fowler comes out of his net, drops it for Gauthier. Below the goal line, Gauthier sits over for Powell. Eamon Powell has the puck on his stick in his last game as an Eagle. Here's Perreault. Across. Gauthier into the offensive zone. Leaves it for Leonard. Leonard can't send it in deep for the Eagles. It's off the glass. Puck sits at the top of the circle. Andre Gasso is there. And Denver is just trying everything they can to play it. Gabe Perreault in the corner, taken away by Denver. Now it's Gasso at the faceoff dot. Over, shot, rebound. Perreault trying to hack at it. It just goes over the net. Couldn't get any closer than that. Here's Powell over for Smith at the left point. Down low, Ryan Leonard. Net is empty. Six attackers on. Smith takes a shot. It goes over the net of Davis. Now it's Cutter in his last game in the Eagles uniform, most likely. Here's Powell at the center point. Powell over for Gauthier at the top of the circle. Powell takes a shot. Save made by Davis. Redirected into the corner by Denver. And then Gauthier plays it in deep for Gasso. 1:51 to go in this third period and the game. And it's sent all the way down by Denver. It's not enough for an icing. 1:43 to go in this third period. And Denver is all about just won this national championship tonight. Here's Will Smith behind his own goal. Over for Eamon Powell. Drops it for Smith. Now it is Gasso. He rims it in deep for the Eagles. Matt Davis comes out of his net, leaves it for his defenseman. And now here comes Denver trying to break it out of their zone. Kept in by BC. Perreault trying to find Leonard. Weak pass. Present played out by Denver. 1:18 to go in the period. Boston College still has the puck. Denver, Behrens has it. Blocked off Gauthier. Gauthier can't find the puck. Bounces it over his stick. 1:09 to go in this third period. 2-0 is the score. Still in favor of Denver.
So many good opportunities. It's just nothing is working for the Eagles right now. Gabe Perreault just got buried into the net. That would have been a more applicable call than the trip, but they're not going to call anything right now. They'd be fools to. But the Eagles, I mean, they've still got those six guys right now. It's on them. I mean, these are the guys who are going to win the national championship now if BC can do it at all. If not, Denver's going to hold on, and they've done a great job of that.
Andre Gasso, Will Smith, Cutter Gauthier, Gabe Perreault, Ryan Leonard, Eamon Powell out there for the last time as an Eagle. Just Eamon Powell, confirmed. Played out all the way down by Denver. 1:06 to go in this game. Cutter Gauthier sprinting back to Icing called on the play by Denver. 1:02 to go in this third period. Boston College still trails 2-0 in the national championship.
Denver fans are just on their feet, waving everything they've got. I mean, they came as a cohort, and they're here to support the team that's on track to win a 10th national title right now.
So, BC wins the faceoff. Gasso over to Powell at the point. Across, Gauthier. Shot blocked by Rizzo. Rizzo has the puck. Gauthier keeps it in the zone. Cutter Gauthier at the top of the slot. Trying to move it across. Taken away by Denver. Cutter Gauthier moves it down low. Ryan Leonard plays it in front. It's off the boards. Cutter Gauthier again at the left point. Now it's Eamon Powell. Over for Smith. He shoots one. Rebound sits in front. Can't be located by Boston College. 38 seconds to go until Denver is crowned national champions of the NCAA D1 hockey.
Yeah, really just tremendous effort by the Denver defense overall. Zeke Boyum is putting every single ounce of effort that he has into this one. Zeke's going to be a highly drafted player. And yeah, just tremendous.
I'm so impressed by Denver right now. They've done such a good job today.
100%. Denver looks like a fantastic hockey team out there. Gasso takes a shot, steered aside by Davis, and then played out of the zone and all the way down by Denver. Denver's going to win the race to get there. 30 seconds to go until they're crowned national champions of Division I men's hockey. Here's Lorenz, taken away. Ryan Leonard has the puck on his stick. Over for Eamon Powell with 20 seconds to go in this game. 19 seconds now. Powell takes a shot. It bounces off the stanchion. 15 seconds to go. Then 12, 11, 10. And that is going to do it, folks.
They let Denver win that icing. It's over.
The University of Denver is your national champion. Their 10th national championship all time. Matt Davis, you are a brick wall. Congratulations on pitching a shutout in the national championship game. You have added yourself to a list that almost nobody is on. Matt Davis, you are a part of history. This entire University of Denver team, Massimo Rizzo, Jack Devine, you guys are amazing, and you're the national champions. Congratulations to the Denver Pioneers.
Just a truly unbelievable season for the Eagles, ending in agonizing defeat. The first team since Maine to win over 20 games in Hockey East play. And it results getting shut out by Denver, who played absolutely perfect. I mean, you can't play better than that. They capitalized on almost every single opportunity Boston College gave them. And they weren't even, I mean, the score times they scored weren't perfect opportunities. They just took what they were given and ran away with the game.
Yeah. Hats off to Denver. Fantastic season. And yeah, Denver by no means was any sort of dominant in the same way that BC was. And a lot of grit went into a lot of their big wins. So congrats to Denver. And now, you know, I think the argument could and should be made that this is the best college hockey franchise. They've won 10 national championships.
Absolutely. This Denver Pioneers team led by Coach David Carl, I mean, what an absolute coaching masterclass from David Carl himself. I could not, if I was a Denver fan, I could not have asked for a better coached game for this Pioneers team as they defeat the Boston College Eagles 2-0 in the national championship. Takes a lot of guts, takes a lot of energy, takes a lot of raw talent to beat this Boston College Eagles team. And speaking of this Boston College Eagles team, a very somber moment. Colby Ambrosio, Eamon Powell, and I believe that is Gentry
Schamberger.
Schamberger embraced for the final time as Boston College Eagles, for the final time as teammates, for the final time as friends. That'll be the last time that those three put on the Boston College jersey for the rest of their lives as players at the Division I level. Congratulations to the three of them on a historic college career. Eamon Powell, we couldn't ask for a better captain. You have led this team with grace. And you have lost with grace, and you have won with grace. This Boston College Eagles team has won over the hearts and minds of the Boston College student body. That's spoken directly from students such as myself, Reynolds, and Brendan. And congratulations to the Denver Pioneers on becoming national champions.
Yeah, and I just wanted to say thank you to to this team for making it an incredible ride for us. We couldn't have asked for a better season to cover this team. And from the three of us to all of them and all of the listeners at home, thank you. Truly, thank you.
Yeah, thank you to everyone, all of our alumni. We couldn't have done it without you. To get here to the Frozen Four, it has made our lives so special in these past few days. We appreciate all of the support that everyone has shown us, both online and in person. WZBC Sports, my name is Jacob Lassner. I'm joined alongside by Reynolds Johoson and Brendan Mahoney. And we are signing off for the final time this season as Denver University has won the national championship in 2024. Congratulations to the Pioneers and their fans.